Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a special edition of PZ85 Horses Play on the Podzilla 1985 Network. Half the show is going to be talking about pop culture, and half of it's going to be PZ85 Plays. This is a hybrid episode. No, I'm just kidding. I was thinking about doing it. If we had started earlier, we would have done that, but since we didn't start early.
You just missed the horse part of the horse play.
You just missed the horse play! Oh, fuck. Why?
How'd you not get that?
Why?
It was right there.
It was right there.
Just like Alex Krycek.
Oh, he was right there. All right, the show started. Hunter, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to another edition of PZ85 Plays. I am your Game Master Double H, and a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, the crew of the Midnight Coterie found themselves at a back alley brawl on Prak City as we continue Episode 9, The Sword of the Empire.
Prak City.
Of the Defiance campaign.
Don't you want to go to Prak City?
I thought you were going to hit me with the Gotham City version. Prak City.
I was trying to.
That voice that you hear as we introduce our cast, as always, we begin with the co-owner and creator of Podzilla 1995, playing Harani Tari, Shannon Young.
Tonight I've switched over to beer for the first time.
Wait a minute. Yeah, I was going to say, let's not go any further.
Root beer.
Okay. Oh, you had me going. I thought you put ice cubes in a beer and I was going to drive to your house. Lindsay Wolfgang is playing Iris Nay, who I would have actually conscripted to punch him for me for that.
Yes. Well, with my luck, I would have fell down the stairs before I got there. So.
You stupid idiot.
She's done it before. The microphone himself, Tanner Calvert, is down there playing Sir Dallin.
Here now. Am I here now? Yeah, I'm here now.
Yeah, it wasn't that actually was not a bit about your mic not working. It was a bit about how your mic sleeve perfectly matches your hoodie.
Mm-hmm. And the background.
And the color of the
yeah.
And down there at the bottom of my screen anyway, we've got this shirt, Cody Sandusky playing Chris Kong Zubane.
You gotta lose your mind in Detroit, Prak City. Get up.
That's where we should have gone with it.
That's where I wanted to go, but I thought I'd save it for a minute.
That's where we should have.
Do you guys,
by the way, I called you that because that's all I can see on your shirt.
Yeah.
Is it just says this shirt.
This shirt saves somebody. we'll see who it saves tonight.
Cody, you, like me, are a fan of the hip-hop and the rap, especially of the early 90s, right?
Yes. I appreciate how you said that, like Bill Cosby in the SNL sketches.
A fan of the hip-hop and the rap music.
Do you remember a little movie, that same era, starring Wesley Snipes and the Ice-T called New Prak City?
I'm glad you went there, because that was the other thing in my head, too.
New Prak City.
And also the famous wrestler slash insane criminal, New Prak.
New Prak. New Prak. I saw New Prak. I couldn't feel my legs.
He said, you ain't going to need them.
threw me off Cloud City.
Last time that I was going to say last week. It was not last week, I don't think, at this point.
No, it was literally yesterday.
The last install. Oh, yeah, that's right. It was... the last installment of the show found our crew discovering that a particular mining company on Praketh might have some answers for them in terms of getting into the Citadel Inquisitorius. However, upon leaving that establishment, they had another chance run-in with Jek Sijo, who is a Duros they met toward the beginning of this series of adventures. Some misadventures, you might say. This time, Jek managed to get himself in trouble with some Compnor thugs. Compnor being the Commission for the Protection of the New Order of the Republic. In other words, Imperial boot lackeys. They're like Capital Rioters, but Star Wars. How about that? Yeah, there you go. It's like that.
Jay Johnston, why? Cody, did you hear about that?
Yeah.
Lindsay, did you hear about that?
About what?
Jay Johnston, who is, you know him as Jimmy Pesto on Bob's Burgers.
Okay.
But I know him as one of the original Mr. Show with Bob and David members. He's been fired from Bob's Burgers because he was at the Capitol during the riots. There's pictures of him at the Capitol during the riots. Come on, man! All right, sorry, Hunter. What's up?
No. So anyway, it's actually one of them is Jay Johnston.
It is.
And he was also playing one of these roles.
Last role in Hollywood you'll ever get.
about six of them were bullying CJ, who ran up to you guys begging for help, saying they're going to throw me down the drains. And as Kruskog, as I recall, sort of stepped in to put CJ between, or to put himself between CJ and these guys, one of them slid out a stun baton and said, "Well, if you like Greeny here, maybe you can have what he's having." And thus we cut it off then. So we're going to begin tonight right in the midst of combat. Quick rundown for you guys. Graz is still rocking a couple of force points for the day, and it is late at the night, so we are nearing up on a 24-hour, need for rest moment. Graz rocking a couple of force points. Harani has 3. Iris has 4. Actually, everyone else has 4. Harani has 3. Iris, Sigurd, and Kruskog have 4. One destiny point apiece for Iris, Sigurd, and Kruskog. Harani is out for the time being. That's where we are. Yes.
Quick note to the you guys that are watching us live. You definitely want to check this out later on podzilla1985.com because I've noticed that our connection is terrible. It is dropping constantly.
Sweet.
But the recording will be fine because I'm recording it live. So go back and listen to it on podzilla1985.com. You can listen to it without interruption or anything like that. So just want to throw that out there.
That's the advantage. The only shame is that you will likely not be able to see the map and such. But, such is life. All right. So with that in mind, as long as we're good, let's jump right into it. Let's first make sure that Shannon gets into roll 20.
I'm going.
I was wondering. I was like, who's at the teller? He's the only one out.
He's just going to tell us when he rolls. It's all 20s.
When you do, we're going to go ahead and begin right out of the gate with some initiative rolls. So if you would roll initiative for me, please. I'm going to roll for Graz.
No, you said you said roll for you.
I'm going first.
And then I'm going to roll for the villains. Okay. And then as you guys get yours, just let me know. Yeah, Graz probably going first. I would be surprised if anyone else beats him on initiative.
Nope. 26 for Kruskog.
26 for Kruskog?
I got a 24.
It's far higher than he normally has.
So. Oh, crap. Once you guys are in roll 20, I totally forgot to move the order so I can give you an idea of what it looks like. So we'll do that now. Zoom, zoom. There you go. You can see sort of the layout of the land here. You guys entered from the north of the map. You entered from the east of the map. Right? Did I have that right? East. West. No. I'll get it right here in a minute. You entered this area from the... No. That's the only one I didn't do. You entered this map from the west. There's like sort of that little western hallway there. Other side. Over
yes,
here.
Yeah,
that one.
Yeah.
Yep.
No, I'm going from cardinal directions.
Jack entered from the north. You can actually see him right here.
Yeah.
He rolled down those steps at the top in that trash can, as you'll recall, and bounced out of it. And then these guys entered behind you guys there. So that's kind of what it looks like. If you need to be moved around, let me know.
What, so these guys are behind us? I knew I recognized them. What are you doing back there, step bro? Hey, Cody, you got that ability where I can re-roll an initiative, right?
Yeah, I do, and that worked.
Well, no, that's actually... Oh, I'm not going to lie. That was for Raynard. I can't pretend. Oh, that was his roll.
Okay. Well, so, clearly, I assume you're probably going to keep Raynard's.
Raynard's is staying. That's short for Spraynard.
Oh, Mama. I just assumed he was acting on your turn. Isn't that what we did last time?
Oh, I thought they had two separate ones.
I'm not picky. If you want to do it that way, you can.
No, I'm fine with doing them at the same time. We can do two at once. So let's say, well, shit. I guess technically it should be 30 then because she has a plus 10 plus that nat 20.
Yeah, we're...
So.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll take
and
it.
Yes,
so, okay.
Force warning is the skill I have that allows you to do that. So,
Hirani, you're acting on 30 and then we need Sigurd's rolls, right?
He's 31.
31.
Son of a bitch.
31.
It's got to be better.
And then I had one more that I needed to get. Oh, the villain ones.
Wait, hold on. Is it like with a nat 20, I get to pick where I am in the order? Or is that the old game?
No, that is, you're thinking of Savage Worlds.
Yeah,
okay.
When you draw a Joker, you get to, technically you still get to choose wherever you want. The further up you are, you can delay your turn. It's just whatever you delay it to, that's your new order in the initiative from that point forward.
Okay.
So, yeah. Yeah.
I'm relearning by reading the core book because I'm running this campaign for my friends starting in January.
Oh, I was going to say, are you actively running it? I knew you were talking about doing it soon.
Yes, we're starting episode one in January.
Nice.
Spoiler alert, my campaign has a droid, so I have to read the droid book to learn some of their stuff.
The droid stuff is really fun when it's done the right way. That's the only thing, you got to really be up on it, because when I ran it the first time, I had a droid as well. I did not know what I was doing, and that thing was ridiculously... They were hitting me with patch notes every day. OP, please nerf. OP, please nerf the droid. It was bad.
Yeah.
It's bad.
The guy that chose to play the droid is a veteran 3.5 player, so I feel comfortable. Mm, at least
so he was definitely looking to min-max as much as possible.
Unfortunately, I've got a guy who's playing a Powan trying to play a Gray Jedi. He's going to be my min-maxer, and I can't wait to nerf that.
Yeah,
that's howdy.
That's bad. Okay, in terms of initiative order... Groz is indeed. By the way, is everybody okay with their starting locations?
I guess the only thing, because I decided to put myself between Jesk and them, like, where would I be? Is that where I need to be?
Technically, you'd probably be like right there.
Okay, that's fine. I just want to know where that.
Yeah,
it's not going to impact my decision
up toward the front anyway.
Okay.
Anybody else need to move?
I would move Raynard next to me on the right. There's no way he's going to stand in front like that.
Okay, I'll switch to the two of you then. I would say you'd probably still be in sort of a knotted group, so how about that?
Yeah,
that's fine. Yeah.
That works. That works for me. Now, the goal was always just to have Harani in the back of the party in general, so...
Real quick, what level are we supposed to be right now?
17.
Okay.
Boy, you...
I didn't like that. I don't like that answer. Tanner?
Text chat for babies.
Yeah. I've got a couple things I got to adjust. I know what they're supposed to be, though.
Well, you go on turn two, so get ready. All right, so Groz is going to go first, and now these guys are drawing weapons. By the way, among these Comnor thugs, agents, they've got, as best you can see anyway, a smattering collection of, a couple of them have like stun batons. A couple of them are pulling blaster pistols, very basic stuff. There's a vibroblade or two among them. And whatever they're not brandishing, the rest of it is probably held from their, like, is on their hilts, on their right. belts. I mean, so they kind of all got the standard loadout. Yeah. the standard array. Right. So Groz can pretty much get to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think Groz can get to anybody except for the red guy in the back. Who would you guys prefer that he go after? Somebody with a ranged weapon, somebody with a vibroblade.
Start ranged.
Yeah, I was about to say, if he can neutralize some threats like that, that may not be a bad idea.
Okay. I'm gonna have him shooting as well, because that way he can stay close to you guys.
Right.
And enact some turns and such.
Hey Lindsay, I got you a Christmas gift. After.
Oh, is it the yellow pebble?
So, yeah, okay. I'm going to have him use his bowcaster. Quick draw the bowcaster. I'm assuming nobody is actively armed as we start this thing. And I'm just going to go ahead and have him take a shot then at this kind of pink guy up here, since he's directly out, one of the furthest out, who's going to be shooting. So here we go. That's a 13. Groz gets a 22, I think, bonus. Yeah. So 13 plus 22 is 35. 35 will indeed hit his reflex.
Ooh, just barely. Damage. Just barely.
Just barely. Just barely. They do get a little stronger the way we go here. 3d10 plus 11 is his damage. All right. Go up. 3d10. Plus 11. Boom. Ah, that sucks. 19 damage Groz deals to old Pinky up there. Pinky in the brain.
Narf.
He's not dead. He's not dead, but he, takes a quarrel to the chest. And Groz is basically, I mean, he's really kicking into the bodyguard role, so I'm not going to have him move because he could give his move away later to use for you guys. He's got a reaction where he's allowed to give you the move as long as you end adjacent to him. I think that's how that works. I need to look that up for sure. So I'm going to end his turn there, and that means that Sigurd, you're up. What do you want to do?
Okay. I think I'm going to try, I want to try to hit orange with force slam.
Pull that up. Okay.
With the intent to try to knock him into the debris behind him.
Okay. Is that, you mean thrust? Slam is the overarching power, isn't it?
Thrust, yeah.
Okay.
So let me see here. So use the force. Twenty-one
versus?
Should be reflex, but it's low. Give me a second here.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Out of harm's way is not a reaction. It's just a move action. But that's good to know. I can use it once you guys start moving away if he stays there.
Okay. Come on, please. Please, computer, cooperate. Okay.
Yes, have some.
Force thrust. Use force thrust to push target away from you. Let's see. Target makes a strength check.
It doesn't target a defense?
No, it says make you use the force check. The target makes a strength check. If you beat the target strength check, you push it back one square, plus an additional square for every 5 points by which you exceed the target's check. Wait a minute here.
Here's going to be the big thing. The target adds base attack bonus and size modifier to its strength check.
Okay, so that one you don't get any bonuses for them slamming into something.
If you push them into a larger object, you deal an additional 2d6 damage.
That's force slam. Mm-mm.
No, that's also force thrust.
I'm reading it.
Oh, boy. Yep.
See, the book I'm reading says force slam.
That's only if you spend a force point, though. You spend a force point to apply a minus 5 penalty.
Yep.
And then, yeah.
Because if you push into a larger object, they take 1d6 point of damage on the initial roll without a force point. Unless that's been changed in the errata. My God, Shannon, that is quite a background, friend.
Terrifying. Please stop. Because you're just sitting there, like, driving beside it, and it just needs to stop.
Well, it's because this is old me versus new me. It's like, you know?
Okay, yeah, let's go with,
it's about the closest I can get.
Okay, so his strength check does not exceed your roll, and you win by, let's see, 1 5-point amount over, so whatever that does.
Two squares.
So you can push him two squares back.
Which would put him against that whatever that object is.
Yeah.
So I'll use the force point to give the additional.
So you roll 3d6 damage. You spend a force point and you hit him with an extra 3d6 damage as he slams into that.
Got the Parker background going now.
It just looks real creepy because I just see big two eyeballs and that's it.
14.
Okay. Noted. I want to see him. Where is he? I can't see him.
I changed it.
Yeah, I'm just going through him. I'm entertaining myself.
Is that a sheep?
That's a Kermit Dreekin.
That's a whiskey.
Yeah.
No, Shannon. That's Moroccan bad Kermit.
That's a Moroccan bad Kermit.
Okay, wow. All
right, so 14 points of damage, he gets thrown back.
Yes, and to finish off, I'm going to go lightsaber defense. So that means my
defense will be plus.
You're using a swift action to draw it, right?
Yes.
Using a swift action to draw it and then enacting defense. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So standard swift, swift. Got it.
Yep.
All right.
So I'm at a 30. I'll be right back.
Hirani, you're up.
All right.
Hirani and Raynard. Sprainard.
Let's see. I think I just have the one. I just have the one gun, don't I? Because I, or do I have any weapon? God, I forget now. I know I gave Cody my lightsaber. I think I did keep a blaster. Yeah, yeah.
I think everybody came single weaponed.
Right, but Cody.
Oh well, Graz has got his melee and his range.
Right. And Cody, you have my lightsaber gun combo. Don't forget, it does both.
Yes,
it does both. Okay.
Seeing how adept I am with neither.
You're a Jedi. How do you know how to use a lightsaber?
I use a light whip.
It's the same thing. They do the same thing. All right.
Just more wiggly.
Yeah, it's more wiggly. We're going to... We're just going to start off with... You know what? Let's see. I can impel. What do I want to do here? Don't want to... Let's just gauge how it goes to start with. I'm just going to take a shot at... the pink one, if I can do that.
Yeah, that's the one that Graz already hit.
We're just gonna gauge the toughness here and see how it goes. So yeah, I'm just gonna take a shot at him with my heavy blaster. That's terrible. 22, and I had a plus 15.
Versus reflex. That is a hit.
Well, I'll be damned. Okay. Three D 8 plus 8. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. 16.
Okay.
Or we're hitting.
He's not dead, but that's the second shot he's taken. So you're taken, so he's definitely off his footing there.
You hit.
And I think I have
You got a swift left after all that. Well, no, you had a swift to draw your weapon. You gotta move left.
Nah, I'll stick. I'll stay. I'll say.
Okay. You can give your move up if you want to. Can't you? Isn't that what Impel Ally is? You use a move to give a move or no?
Yeah, I just don't know who would benefit from that. Probably.
That's up to you guys. I mean, you can move Graz, but Graz has currently got a
right. He's in range weapon. Yeah. I could send Sigurd up there, but he'll just die.
Sigurd
will just die if I send him up there. Because it's a level 17 fight and he's a level 12 character at the moment, so let's just end it.
Well, you still got Raynard. Sprainard.
We'll go to Sprainard. Sprainard doesn't
Bernard.
Really. I forgot he does actually have abilities. Born leader, coordinate, and trust. I don't know what any of them do because I've never used him in combat. And I'm not gonna look it up either because I don't feel like it. So he's also just gonna take a shot at pink.
Yeah, do it.
He has a plus 9, so. I almost did a 1d30. Is that a thing? All right.
I don't know. I mean, I've never seen one.
No.
Let's just move on.
Oh.
Let's just move on.
That will not hit.
Yeah.
We'll say Hirani's shot kind of staggers this guy, and so Raynard's goes wide in the process. He kind of gets thrown to the side. You guys are firing simultaneously.
That's sweet of you.
it's the season. Tis the season. Kruskog, you're up.
Hey, don't know what to do with myself this early in a combat initiative. Which one of these gentlemen?
Delay.
Which one
if
of these
you
gentlemen?
Delay, Iris is next.
Just let her riddle holes through everybody and I can ask questions when everyone's dead. which one of these guys, I'm assuming, is it Blue, the one closest to Jess, is the one that pulled out the, Vibroblade at the end of the last session.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay.
He's the one talking, too. He's the one who's been running his mouth.
Okay. Then, let me just make a quick note of how my things do this here. That's right, because that's a standard action.
In the middle of the show, it'd be funny if we just started giving spoilers for Spider-Man.
Yeah,
nobody knows.
That'd be funny.
So I want a new master negotiator while Uncle Ben dies.
Uncle Ben makes some good ass rice.
The rice guy?
Yeah. Way to cotton.
You do master negotiator?
Way to cotton pick a man and Uncle Ben.
Well, you know, with great with great power comes great responsibility.
Oh, Meatwad speaks.
He did his lips. All right, so.
Oh, no.
That ain't good.
Okay.
We're losing so Cody. There he is.
Negotiator.
Okay.
Oh, we're losing me?
Briefly,
yeah. Your video's real choppy.
Very. Oh, yeah. My internet is taking a dump.
Well, he made that face, and okay, that's now the good. New face to Cody for the rest of the campaign.
No. Oh, okay.
Hang on. I gotta save this. I need a record of this so when Cody comes back, he can see that the whole time that his shit was fucking up, that this is what he looked like.
Hey, Cody.
Please.
Hey, Cody.
He said he's going to use Master Negotiator, but off the top of my head, I don't remember what that does. I can just look it up, I guess.
I think it breaks your internet. Oh, yeah.
There we go. Ooh.
Good Lord, what a screen cap. That's incredible. I have no idea what happened there.
I needed a record of that because that's the face that you were making the entire time. We could hear you going, oh, no. Oh, this is bad.
Well, saving that image because that needs to be kept.
Hey, so
okay,
did we?
Yeah, so I'll do Master Negotiator's as a standard action.
Master Negotiator,
right?
Blue.
So it's
and this
a
does what now?
Persuasion check.
Okay.
Against Master Negotiator
his will, I'm gonna guess.
Is, yes, yeah, his will defense.
That's how you
so
drop his
condition
track, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. So as that is happening, it's a persuasion check, but I also have force persuasion, which means I use my use the force modifier for that. So
yeah,
this is going to be a d20 plus 22. Not a great roll, but it's 31.
Jeff. Versus his will, yeah, that's a success. Do you need to know like by how much again? Is that a thing?
No, the only thing is if he's a higher level than me, he gets a bonus to his will defense, but I'm going to assume probably not right now.
He is not.
I was going to make the meanest joke I could. I'm not going to. You can't make me.
Okay, then. That's great. Then we had this moment
together. You beat his will. What happens?
He is going to go minus 2 on the condition track.
Okay, so it just drops to his spaces.
Yep. So it's going to drop 2 spaces on the condition track and generally just start to communicate to him. You seem to be a very angry individual, and I'm sure this person has wronged you, as you have probably put together. We know him well enough to be willing to defend him, and believe me, I don't like him much either. But I seem to like you far less, so I recommend you put up your weapons and go ahead and step away from this situation, because, as the friend back and to your left could probably show you, it's back. Not going well.
It's to the left. Back. It's to the left. Okay, you got a move and a swift left.
I do. And I just need to check because I don't remember which one of these things is swift action. Nope, that's a standard. Okay, I think most of my things are standards because, you know, force powers. So, move at this point. I'm going to, I'll move, put me 2 paces closer to our very dumb friend.
Okay, just move you straight up.
Oh, I meant to the right toward our hobbled alien.
Our dumb friend.
Yes. Yeah.
you more emphasis on friend than dumb. Got it.
Yeah, well, I mean, depending on how our interactions have gone so far. Yeah,
between the two. Okay, noted.
Right. Yes. So then I will keep my swift in my pocket. I'm good for now.
Cool. Iris, you're up.
I'm going to quick draw my heavy blaster, and I'm going to aim at yellow and take a shot.
Yes. That's something you can do.
You may try.
Waiting for the internet.
We will try.
Hey, I have an announcement to make.
Yeah.
Starting in the new year, I've decided to finally make two... Never mind, she's already rolled.
22.
Okay, versus reflex?
Yes.
That's a hit. It was a hit before, it's a hit now.
I'll save my announcement for a later time.
Go ahead, it's going to take me a little bit to type all this in.
No, I've already given up on it.
Are you running for president in 2024?
I've decided that that I'm going to make 2022 the year I finally make something out of me health-wise. So I'm going to do my best to give up both pizza and soda for the entire year and just go to water and healthier food. Because by the end of the year, I want to be so attractive that the gods themselves will touch themselves to me.
Themselves.
Themselves.
37.
In a row?
How much?
37 damage.
Go! Okay.
In a row?
It's hard.
It does.
I have a
hard.
Lot of bonuses.
So that pushes him a step down on the condition track. I can tell you that much off the top of my head without even doing the rest of the damage here. Okay. Yeah, he's hurt. He's hurt bad. He's real bad. You messed him up. That was a solid shot.
That's everything.
Not even the other two shots that have nailed the pink guy there have hit as hard as that. Like that was the real deal. So okay. Then that'll bring us to them. They are dead last in the initiative. I think I'm just gonna go Viral Blade, Pistol along the back. That makes the most sense. So Orange, having been force thrusted, is quite upset. And he is going to, with his Viral Blade, move in. However, Sigurd, as much as you probably thought he was coming after you, he's not. He's going after Iris. In fact, he's going to end his turn right there, and he's going to take a swipe at her with his Vibro Blade. Iris, what's your reflex?
39.
Yeah, he's going to miss. he's going to miss. Yellow's going to do much of the same, only he's going to move up on Graz. He's going to avoid Sigurd, and he's going right after Graz. I think he's also going to miss. Yes, he is. And then Blue's got a Viral Blade too. Kruskog, he's trying to shake off the whammy jammy that you put onto him. He's coming after you. What's your reflex?
My reflex is now 32.
It's higher than that, and he misses. All right.
Cool.
of the remaining ones, let's see. Pink is going to take his shot at Graz. He will miss. Green. Wait, who's just stepped down on the condition track? Oh, it was yellow. All right, he missed anyway. Oh, yeah, and Blue's doing poorly, too. Green is going to take his shot at... He's going to actually shoot at Cijo. He's going to miss, though. He fires over in this sort of general direction. These guys are kind of just firing blindly and attacking blindly into the crowd. Red is probably the most interesting of them all, though, because rather than immediately taking a shot or anything, he first shouts up the steps for help. He starts calling for, you know, we need help down here. There's a group of undesirables causing chaos. We need help immediately. And then he's going to turn and take a shot at, who can he see? I don't know, Kruskog, he's going to shoot at you.
Okay.
Oh, shit, what is your reflex again?
32.
Yeah, that's going to hit.
Cool. Because I've never used this power, I don't know how this works, so I'm going to ask in the moment. I have four shield, which is a reaction.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In terms of the scheme of things, that's the part I don't know in terms of how the attack happens versus the reaction of the shield.
Reaction comes up. It's a reaction to something happening. So, yeah, that's the whole point of the power. That's the idea.
Cool. Okay. Then I would like to use Force Shield if something's going to shoot at me.
Okay. And that does what exactly?
It's a make use the Force check. The result of the check determines the result, if any. Basically, I gain a shield rating until the end of my next turn, or beginning of my next turn.
Okay.
And unlike other shield ratings, it's made of pure telekinetic energy and cannot be recharged by any means.
Gotcha. It's like a one-off.
Yeah.
Okay. Do it.
That's 38, which is the max I can do.
So you have a shield rating of 38, basically?
I have a shield rating of 20.
Of 20,
yeah,
okay.
The DCs go 15, 20, 25, 30.
Okay, I got you. So I still need to roll the damage.
Right.
And then...
And this is where I'm honestly most curious about using the powers. I wanted to see what the mechanic looked like in terms of damage versus all that.
So you take no damage.
Oh, cool.
He deals 14 damage that does not penetrate your shield, and yeah, his blaster bolt, basically you just, you know, throw up an arm, and his blaster bolt just, bing, dissipates cool. at the edge of it.
So does the shield rating diminish by that number of damage points?
That is usually how it works, okay. Yes. Yeah, usually your shield rating is like a second round of hit points, basically.
Right. That's so, what I thought it was the case.
Okay. Can you use that every time? You have Can you
it's
use
a
that?
Force power.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you can only use it once per encounter unless he starts spending force points to get it back.
To get back, right. Or yeah. Because of the telekinetic, if I roll a nat 20 based upon a feat I have, I get it back automatically. But we know the Kruskog system. That's not a thing to worry about.
Yeah, Force Shield basically reminds me a lot of Mage Armor. Yeah. That's the same concept from D&D, pretty much.
Very cool.
Okay, yeah, so his bolt rebounds off of you ineffectively. And we're back to the top with Groz. Groz, who now has somebody directly in front of him and can no longer make ranged attacks without moving and provoking an attack of opportunity or attacking instead. So, I don't know about you guys, but I think this would be a good time for Groz to switch over to melee.
I think so.
Given that he is kind of locked down there.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to spend two of his swift actions to swap weapons. He's got to put one away and then get the other one back. I don't want to drop it. I don't like the idea of him dropping his bowcaster. But he's going to switch over to the vibro axe, and he is he's going to go swing. And he's going to hit. He's going to hit real hard. Yellow's already not in good shape because Iris tore him up, tore him a new one. So 2d10 plus 16. Hey, I'm not even going to roll. Homeboy had 18 hit points left. Groz hits for 2d10 plus, am I reading that right? Plus 12. Yeah, 16. So even if he rolled two ones,
yeah,
he's going to kill him. Yeah, it's pointless. So. Done. He deals a minimum of 18 damage. So, yeah, this guy rolled up on him and figured out very quickly that he made a grave mistake, more literally than maybe he anticipated.
Uh-huh.
And that's going to spend all of Gross's actions, though, because he had to switch weapons, so he's right. Locked down where he is. Harani, you're up.
Well, you would think that, but what's going to happen?
No.
Sorry, hang on. Sigurd. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to move down here to in front of Orange here.
Okay.
What's Agent Orange?
Agent Orange. And I'm going to take a two-handed
Asian
attack.
Orange?
See, I thought we were going to go Mr. Orange. You know, I thought we were going to go Reservoir Dogs, but okay.
Orange is the new black.
Mr. Pink.
Mr. Black.
Anyway, you swinging your lightsaber?
Yeah, two-handed.
Okay. I should note to you, by the way, you were kind of in and out from that, but the moment that lightsaber appeared, there was some commotion.
I figured.
Just for the record, this is not like, oh, it's a Jedi. This is, what now? Say what? There's a Jedi. So when they called for help, like there were mentions of Jedi. Like the word Jedi came up more than once.
I would like to add, when I pulled the lightsaber out, I said, "Let me whip this out," because it was still in my pants.
Tanner always whipping it out. God, sure. I miss that meme.
I do too.
That's good.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
All right, take your swing, boy.
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 So what do you like to do? Well, play chess. Screw. Let's play chess.
I need to watch that again. It's been so long.
29?
Yeah, it hits the reflex.
Okay.
The reflex.
So
Orange has not been hit yet, for the record. No, he's been hit once. You hit him.
Do that Krampus tonight? How you gonna do that Krampus?
No, I've killed Krampus 3 times already. I'm good. I don't need to do that anymore.
I haven't. He's killed me.
23 damage.
Okay. 23. Not dead. Injured. You catch him on a side glance. You score him, like burn him, basically.
As a Swift,
hurt, but not dead.
Lightsaber defense again.
Okay. Yeah, he tries to like parry your blow with that vibro blade, and I mean it does to a certain degree, but it's not a great defense of that. I guess that's that's everything. Hirani, you're up. Also, I found out it's really easy to kill Krampus when he's not hunting you.
Right.
You see him hunting someone else, you just turn around and kill him and you're good.
He's always hunting me though. Asa messaged me today, by the way, and said, I have no interest in Final Fantasy and I don't like MMOs. Why do I want to play Final Fantasy 14 so bad now?
Because it's pretty.
And like, cause you can't. Right, you can't.
It's, yeah, that's it. You want to do it because you can't do it.
Yeah, you're gated that's out. All. You're gated out right now, son.
Wait, what happened?
Final Fantasy 14, they stopped.
I'll tell him.
Yeah, yeah, message
it. I'll tell him what you're doing.
Oh, well, this is going to be a very simple thing. I want Graz. I'm going to use Impel Ally to have Graz move and attack.
Okay. Where's he going?
Probably blue. Well.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do blue. Yeah.
Okay.
So they stopped.
Oh, you can tell him, I guess, while I'm rolling all this stuff.
Yeah, so since Endwalker came out. Yeah, Endwalker came out, and it's so popular that son of a bitch did a son of a bitch thing, and they stopped selling them. Oh hell! Oh lord!
Oh lord!
That's because of what happened originally.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do just to expedite the process. Rather than coming up with some random shit that happens to Graz, I'm just going to cost him one of his force points. He misses the shot. He misses the attack. Nothing happens, but he doesn't like drop his weapon or I'm not here for it tonight. It's too late for that. I'm going to cost him a force point. We're going to call it a day.
He catches Kruskog in the face with the axe by accident.
Hey, remember that force shield I got left? Not anymore.
That would be it, basically. He rebounds off the rest of that. No, I'm just going to cost him a force point and say be done with it.
All right.
Which means then, Kruskog, you're up.
Wait.
Yeah, I sure am.
No, he's not.
He still has...
You still have stuff after Impel Ally 1 and 2?
Rainer.
The helper.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I need to put him right here. I didn't write him beside that. All right, now. Yes, Rainer. Two things.
Since I'm still too lazy to look up what his abilities are, he's just going to take another shot at, let's say, I don't know, Mo. No, at Blue. He's going to take a shot.
Don't kill Mo.
He's going to take a shot at Blue. All right.
Yeah. He came to life. Good for him.
19. That's
the that is a miss. That is not a hit.
Well, he doesn't have any force points, so let's move on.
All right. Now it's Kruskog.
See how easy I make it?
I just don't hit anything. It's great. Okay.
Oh, shit. Actually, Kruskog, he does.
You are pressed for the record.
I was wrong. He gets 2 force points. I'm going to use a force point.
Oh, okay. Do it.
I did not know that he did that. I'm so sorry, Cody. It's what is
now,
it?
He, I don't know that he gets 3d6. I don't know what level. Is he considered to be your level?
Yes.
Okay, then yes, he does get 3d6 and you pick the highest.
Okay.
Yeah, that's based on the level.
I'm pretty sure because he's like a superior minion, he's the same level as me.
Gotcha.
5, I guess, would be the highest one. So 24.
Yeah, that'll do it.
All right. So he's got 3d6 plus 2. He doesn't hit very hard, but, you know.
Hey,
no, he's a minion. They're not meant to be. Right. There's just some multiple chances for an attack.
He got a 10. That's not terrible.
10 damage. That's not 10. That's
I thought he got terrible. A 10 on both rolls.
He did. Creepy.
Actually, I shouldn't have even made never mind. We're good. No, we're good. You're good. Cool?
Good.
Kruskog, you're up.
All right, so the force shield comes down, which is probably not great, seeing as I'm pressed by a blue guy.
Because
That also means that I don't have any ability to back up without taking AoE.
I will point out to you that you are adjacent to Graz, which means that he can take damage once per round for an adjacent ally. So unless you just need to move to do something,
right?
You don't necessarily need to move away.
I'll say, yeah, because all my force powers are based upon the fact that I just need to be within 12 squares in line of sight. So,
If I had known that you were mostly a force power, if I had paid attention and realized you didn't actually use the weapon at all, I would have kept my damn lightsaber.
I mean, spoiler alert, we can do that after this.
We must. She's going to be disappointed.
You're hearing this if you wanted.
Throw it to me as a swift action.
That is not a swift action.
Have you also seen how bad Kruskog is at most rolls that don't involve the force?
Do you want to get out of storm drain? It would be a swift action.
Because that's how it goes down a storm drain. You know what? He's standing in front of me. I'm just going to take him two more points down the condition track.
Okay.
So that's a 1d20 plus 22. It's 26. How does that go up against his will defense?
Will? Yeah, that beats his will.
Okay. Yeah, so we're going to use Master Negotiator and again take him down two steps. So I'm going to look at him and again say, I realize your friend there decided to alert maybe some more of your compatriots. I would look to my right and recognize again, this is not going in your favor. And will continue to not go in your favor. I wish not to harm you physically, but I will if I must.
He's very close to just pissing himself, basically. He's four steps down on the condition track, which is at a minus 10 for everything. That also means he's a step away from unconscious.
Yes, which, so, if we get to that step,
he's going to pass out from fear.
Yes, that's what it would be. Yeah,
yeah. Just to note, if he gets to that step, he does not fall unconscious. Instead, he cannot attack me or my allies for the remainder of the encounter unless myself or one of my allies attacks him or one of its allies first.
Okay.
Which also
so
means
he's basically frozen in fear at that point.
So just kind of keep in mind, I probably won't put him down any further because that would... we would ruin it as soon as we attack one of their people, so that's kind of a last-ditch effort. But yeah, minus four on the condition track is hopefully helpful.
Yeah. Noted. What else?
That's... right now, well... because that's a standard action, so that leaves me a move and a swift. Mm-hmm. And a move doesn't turn into action economy. Move can be stepped down to a swift.
Yeah. Standard move, swift.
Right. I don't think any of my things can be done with a swift. Because I was trying to think if I could recover my force powers, but that's not any of that.
If there's one thing I really still remember from Penny Arcade that I really liked, by the way, keep thinking, Cody, you're fine. It was that back when D&D 4th edition came out, they had a similar action economy, but it was called standard move and minor, if you guys remember, minor instead of swift. And I remember one of the guys, I think the guy who did the writing, and I can't remember who's who, but he suggested that a D&D themed band should really name themselves Move Minor Standard. And I was like, I really like that. It sounds goofy as hell in the best way, and it has stuck with me ever since. One of these days, I'll act on it. Anyway.
Yeah, I don't have anything, so I'll go ahead and just stay where I'm at. What would have been? Well, I'm sitting here thinking it was Gabe or Tycho.
I don't remember who's who. I want to say it's the latter.
Yeah.
Iris, you're up.
I'm going to leave orange to Sigurd. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to stay put and
oh, that'd be a bad idea because you're adjacent to him.
I am. Okay, uh-huh. Well then, yeah, take me
corners
up.
Are touching.
Boo. All right, then go ahead and I'll take a step back between Harani and the dead body of yellow.
So back there?
Yeah.
Or up there, depending on
which whichever. Okay. Whichever. And then that being the case, then yeah, I'm going to go ahead and shoot at orange since he came at me.
Yeah, that's a good plan.
The dead body of yellow was one of Hunter's bands back in college.
Yes.
It was a good one. It was its time.
I think we're gonna use that for the lead single for Move Minor Standard.
The dead body
of yellow.
That's
going to be the name of the dead body of yellow. Maybe the first album. I don't know. We'll see.
Hunter, do you remember when I put out that fake rap album and certain someone messaged you and asked you, can he do that? Can he legally say that people are going to be on that?
It was Jake. You could just say it. Stupid. It was the funniest thing. I still think that was hilarious. What's that?
35.
Oh, yeah, that's a hit.
The name of the album was...
we need to do more of those.
Why am I still alive? And it still rings true to this day.
Parker was on several tracks.
He was on a couple. Well, he's Grandmaster P. He's Master P.
He makes him say, oof.
Oof.
29 damage.
Is that on orange again?
Limit soldiers.
Yes.
Oh, he's dead.
Good.
He's so dead. He's very dead. Actually, you also didn't need to roll. He only had 18 hit points left. You could not have possibly rolled less than that.
That's fine.
Yeah, Sigurd steps back in and lightsaber defense is up, and the moment that he does, a bolt just passes through that guy's head, and he hits the ground.
And she rolled so high, it hit him extra hard because she pushed the gun forward when she shot, so it did extra damage.
It's like when you're playing Mario Kart and you turn the controller.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Or like when Steven yells when he's playing games and that makes him better at the game.
Right. Because Steven will go 56-3 and be like, well, that's the...
He actually did say that, I think. That's, yeah, that's accurate. I'm assuming that's all for Iris.
No, I'm going to do one of my new things. I finally have something I can use a Swift for.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to use my battle analysis. It's a DC 15 on a tactics roll. Mm-hmm. And if I succeed, I'll know basically anyone that's in with my line of sight, whether or not they're at half damage or less.
Ooh, that's cool. So you had to pick one, or like anybody you can
see? It says anything within sight.
Oh, nice.
I know who is at half damage or less. If they're not at half damage, I don't get an answer on it.
You don't get anything. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, though.
That's very cool.
Now she's going to roll a 7.
We'll see what... Well, actually, since it's on a D15 and my... bonus is a plus 16. I really can't completely fail it, I don't think.
Are there any like bonuses that you can get for getting higher than that, or
not that I can see on it? All it says, where I had it pulled up. Give me a second.
I'm looking it up. I want to see.
As a swift action, you can make a DC 15 knowledge tactics check. If check succeeds, you know which allies and opponents within your line of sight are reduced to at least half of their maximum total hit points. Is all.
Yeah, that's all it says. And you have a plus 16 to knowledge of tactics.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't have to roll that because you can't crit fail. I mean, it doesn't matter. You can't crit fail it. So there's literally no way to get less than that. So yeah, as a swift action, you just do that. And I can tell you that none of your allies are reduced to half their hit points. Yellow and orange are quite literally reduced
They're
to none
dead.
Of their hit points. and currently, of the remaining enemies in the area, pink is below half his hit points. The rest are not.
Yeah.
But I cannot say anything
will
more specific.
Share
than
with
that.
My team that pink is hurting and probably go down quick.
yeah, anybody who looks his direction sees his eyes go wide of like, oh. Well, that ain't good.
Howdy, partner.
Howdy, partner.
Howdy, partners.
And now I'm spent.
Okay. That's
you know,
cool.
After all that hard work you did, I think you're good. I did it for the entire battlefield. Good lord.
I made myself more useful.
All right. So as we get around to the villains, the first thing that's going to happen... Well, okay. I guess he's not first in the lineup. I'll start in the back there. Pink, Mr. Pink, he don't like that. Bob Dole doesn't like that. So he's going to take a shot at you, first of all, because he's
fuck
quite
you,
upset that you're telling everyone
get,
to focus fire on him.
Snitches get stitches.
Snitches get stitches. Yeah, oh yeah, yeah. Not really, though, because he's too terrified.
He can try, but he ain't gonna help.
That shot goes so wide. It's so bad. And bad. Then he's just going to start running. Or 5, 6... He's going to get to about here. It's clear that he's not interested in engaging in this anymore. This is a bad idea for him. His buddies are not so convinced. Between the two of them, Green is going to take a shot at you, Iris. He is also going to miss. And then Red Kruskog is going to take a shot at you. He, by the way, continues shouting for help.
Oh!
Well, maybe I should have shaved that force shield for this turn.
Can't you use a force point, though?
No, he would have had to have done that to get it back then.
Yeah, I'd had to recover it before this moment.
Bye, Cody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he only deals 22 damage on a max damage, so it's not he's not going to kill you.
It's uncomfortable.
But he looks like the most emboldened at this point of all of them. You would have thought it was Blue. He seems to be the de facto leader, but Red seems pretty comfy back there toward the top of the map near the steps. Probably can make an easy getaway, and so he has a little more time to and plus, you know, he knows the attention's not on him right now, so he's able to focus and just tag you pretty good there. With that, he's actually going to move over here behind these crates to give himself some cover. It's not perfect. It's like a half-height cover thing, but it's a little something for him. Blue. You and Groz both, now I don't know, I guess it'll be an unarmed melee, because you don't have a weapon out, I don't think, do you?
No.
Kruskog? You also don't have to take it, but you're going to get attacks of opportunity because Blue is going to bolt for the hills. He is horrified
Run
at the idea
the
that
hills.
Yeah, he's convinced that you guys are going to murder him in cold blood as far as he's concerned here. So,
Well, yeah, he's standing next
to a Wookie. He's out. Groz is, for the record, going to take a swing at him. Yeah,
just physical, so it'd be
That's two in a row!
God dang.
Two in a row.
Groz is borrowing from that Kruskog system. He's getting away from Kruskog. It rubs off.
I can't do it twice. He's going to drop his weapon. Yep. Groz goes to swing as this guy takes off, and he just kind of like freaks out, and he swings too hard, and he drops his weapon.
His hands are
going to pick it up.
He
seems to
take off, and he's just like, ah.
His palms are sweaty.
Yeah.
Mom's spaghetti.
Knees weak. Yeah. Arms are heavy. You can take one if you want there, Kruskog.
Yeah, what's the unarmed strike for my character?
It's a basic, you get your base attack bonus plus any strength bonus that you might have.
My base attack bonus goes down by one. My strength is a minus one.
And then if you hit, I think it's literally just like a d4 plus your strength.
Right, so it's minus my strength.
Roddy's just going to yell out, somebody use the goddamn lightsaber.
Well, I can't pull
we can't right now.
Yeah, I'll say yes.
Yeah, he doesn't have the ability in the moment. Because
my base attack bonus is my level, so it's plus 17.
Just throw a grape at him.
Maybe that's what this is going to be.
He got any grapes.
24.
He got any grapes?
That is a hit, actually.
I've taken him so far down, I hope it would be.
He's going to slap fight him.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I didn't think about that. Well, Groz rolled a one anyway.
It doesn't matter. That's
a hit.
Honestly, that's what I was kind of hoping would happen when he started to get a little bit careless and Groz would be able to take him down, but,
Nope.
So you said it's a D4.
D4 plus your strength, so I guess minus
D4
your strength.
D4 minus one.
Yeah.
Zero!
Holy shit!
Oh my God.
All that build up for nothing, kids.
Holy shit!
I don't know what to do with that. This is legitimately one of those DM moments where I'm like, no, he can't not deal any damage. But like, if the strength is that low, he can literally not deal any damage. Make contact.
Just smacks him in the back of the head.
But it's more like, with like his back, like his jacket as he's getting away. I mean, you technically make contact. You just don't hurt him in any way.
No. I'll tell you what it is. This is Venkman smacking Ray in the back of the head when he's interrupting him at the beginning of Ghostbusters. Right in the middle of
that deals damage.
Ray.
Like, that's at least one.
fair. Never mind.
That's at least one point of damage.
True.
No, I'm this is literally just you tag his clothes or something. Like, you make contact. It just doesn't. It doesn't faze him
Kruskog
in any way whatsoever.
Doesn't get involved in much physical combat if you can't tell.
God. It was kind of like you didn't expect him to run and you do that, like, hey.
Get back here.
Just,
get back here.
Yeah.
He's looking
so beyond that.
Hey.
He's got, because, I mean, he was just moving, so nothing interrupts his move. He's going to double move off the map. He is running for his life.
Also, Tanner, I don't think you're on the right microphone.
Uh-oh.
I just noticed.
Either that or you're just too far away from it. You are a little echoey.
Yeah.
With that, before we rotate to the top of the order.
How about now?
There you go.
Yeah, it's kind of quiet, but
but it's good, yeah. Turn it up. Banging it.
Turn up my headphones. Turn my headphones up.
Or snare in the monitors.
How about now?
Not.
There you go.
Better.
That's good. That's what you want. How do I? There we go. Okay. From what would be, it's the east of the map. However, you guys are oriented at this point in time. You hear sounds, footsteps moving in quickly. And just like that, a couple of new combatants appear.
Here come the goddamn death troopers.
These you would recognize as what are known as Sovereign Protectors, Imperial Sovereign Protectors. They look, if you can see the image, it's very small. They look a little bit like Royal Guards, but with more like black armor than red. These guys also have double viral blades, like staves, and they come rushing in with those. You don't actually hear them say anything, but it's pretty clear they're here for you.
Bad eyesight, it looks like Deadpool with a cape.
That's pretty accurate, yeah. That's not inaccurate, for sure. And it appears that the help that they called for has arrived. What's, I guess, maybe good is that they do not appear to have noted Seijo's appearance. But they see you guys real quick, and they see that the situation is getting out of hand. So they're going to enter combat. Actually, I need to roll some initiative for them. Okay.
But that's going to extend the combat.
Yes, it is. You guys should have ended this earlier. All right, we're back to the top of the order with Graz. Graz now no longer has an immediate enemy before him. So with Pink injured, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ah, Graz can't get to him. That sucks. Tell you what, I don't know about you guys, but it feels like Graz would probably be best used against the new guys who just showed up.
Sure.
Maybe. Possibly. I don't know. It's up to you guys. I can have him move in on the Comptor agents too, but
no, I agree with you, but he does have to pick up his weapon.
That's true. So I'm going to get... Well, the good news is, since he has quick draw, he can pick it up with a swift action.
Cool.
He can then spend his move action moving in. He just can't enact Wookiee Rage or anything like that, which is what I was going to have him do. And he will swing his Vibro Blade at the red one there.
Hey, those are more the rolls we like.
Plus 22 is 38. That is a hit. It is indeed a hit. For the record, before anybody freaks out.
I don't like the way he said it, though. He had to think about it. That ain't
I
good.
Just didn't know. I had to go look, you know. 2d10 plus 16. 2d10 plus 16. 32 days.
There you go. There you go, Graz.
Those are good numbers.
Those are good numbers.
Forget about it.
You got to do some math. We'll just go to the next person since I've already done that. So, Sigurd, you're going to be up next while I'm doing this math. How are you going to do that math?
Okay, I can move through allies, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so... Okay, I'd like to move here next to my friend Graz.
Okay. And cut off that agent.
Two-handed lightsaber attack.
Right.
Dead air.
24.
That is a miss.
A 24, yeah, will not hit his reflex, no.
Okay, I'm using force point.
Okay. I'll put you down to 2.
I got an 8. I got 2 8s.
So what's that put you at? A 32?
Yep.
A 32 will hit.
Okay.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
Damage.
Should have mentioned, Graz also knocked him down a step on the condition track. That's going to knock him down another step. You said 29?
Yep.
Okay. He is not dead, but he is hurting.
And lightsaber defense.
Yeah, okay, yeah, you've got a swift left. Yeah. Sounds good. Sigurd, Kruskog. No, not Kruskog. Hirani. Hirani and Raynard, you're up. Yep.
Hirani's just going to look at Graz and just say, she's just going to, it's like the Santa Baby skit with Vanessa Bayer and Ryan Gosling. When he looks back at her, she just shakes her head and goes, no, Graz.
Oh, that one.
Yeah. Graz, finish him.
Okay. Impel ally, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Oh. Let's see. 5, what's he get? A 22? With a 27, Graz is not going to hit his reflex.
But he's knocked down the condition track.
Even with the condition track?
Yeah, he's down 2. Yep. So technically he's hitting another, rolling a 29. That also does not hit.
Damn.
Use a force point.
I was going to say, he has one force point left if you want him to use it.
At the end of the day, may as well.
Yeah, I didn't know they could on my command.
Mm-hmm. It's just an attack roll.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
anytime you take an attack roll, you can do it.
Let's do that. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. 3d6. Hang on. Kill that.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the 6 will do it. That puts, I forget what total that puts him at, 34 or something, but yeah, you guys well know at this point that'll do it. All right, yeah, so Groz hits, so it's 2d10.
What, Groz and Harani really have a disconnect right now. They're distant.
It's that, well, she's got that that whole new persona going on. Here's Groz. Groz is actively moving. Actually, it really reflects in the theming and the game mechanics too. Groz is moving toward a protector role, a very sort of, you know, keep people safe kind of guy. Whereas Ronnie is doing everything she can to put herself in harm's way constantly. Now it's a whole new dynamic for
them. It's the influence of that damn Imperial Reynard and that damn Sasquatch.
He's gonna deal 24 damage. That's not going to kill him still yet, but it is, he's in bad shape at this point. That guard showed up and we chose violence today with him. Okay, you got whatever you got left. I don't remember what that one does. Standard, I think.
I think I have,
you can attack still.
Can I?
Yeah.
What is that? Impel two, ally two?
Two yeah. Swifts. Yeah. Impel ally 2 counts as 2 swifts, so he still gets an attack.
All right, well then.
Tanner, I gotta ask, how do you know his power is better than yours?
I wasn't gonna say it.
Well, Harani's gonna kind of look at.
Use that one a lot.
She looks at Groz and just kind of sighs and aims her blaster pistol at the guy.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, wait a minute.
For the record, this guy is like parrying these blows with his. He's got a double vibroblade, so he's doing what he can, but.
I very much love Tanner's hesitation at this because, boy, if you, there 30, you go. Yeah, you gotta worry about Tanner.
That is a hit.
Tanner's worried about getting a blaster bolt buried in the back of his head.
Wouldn't be the first time.
I'm pushing the narrative forward by having Harani be slightly disappointed that Groz couldn't kill him in one shot.
You thinking he's holding back.
I'm thinking, yeah, Harani's thinking that he's going soft on her, and while she's getting more vicious and bloodthirsty, it's a character arc, man. It's going places. that is going to be not a great attack, though. 18.
Yeah, it's going to be enough to finish him, though.
That's what I'm saying. She,
before that guy even gets to act,
yeah.
Wiped.
Harani looks at Grush.
Wiped out.
She sighs, and then she instantly deletes him.
Yeah. Instantly, if he was Steven, he'd be asking how he got instantly deleted like that.
she points that you can still see the smoke coming from it, and she just kind of stares coldly.
Oh yeah,
as he falls dying, how'd you even get me?
How'd you shoot me?
I gotta move him around real quick so I can mark the X on him.
As he gets shot, he just looks at the blaster bolt, and goes what, and dies.
I'm assuming that's all you have.
That's all I got.
Okay. Oh, Reynard.
Yes. Reynard looks at her and just kind of smirks to himself. And then he's going to aim at Green and take a shot.
Okay. Green and Red, for the record, the only two uninjured of the original combatants.
Oh, actually, yeah. Now that you say that, I completely forgot. Pink is still there. Can I shoot at Pink instead?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
No witnesses.
Don't matter unless he's that far on the condition track that a 13 is going to get her done.
It will not hit. No, he hasn't.
I don't know why Lindsay said that like that. No Russian mission at the end there in the middle of Modern Warfare 2.
No witnesses.
I like the tone of that.
She's borrowing from Bob. Double H said no snitches. Cody, we'll tell you that story when this is over.
Awesome. I appreciate right. that.
That's that is a miss, which means we got to move on. We are indeed moving to the remaining sovereign protector, the only one who is currently alive. And let's see. Sigurd has lightsaber defense up. God, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's going to move right in on Harani. He really is. He's going to move right up toward her. He's going to bypass you guys completely, and he's going after her.
I was about to say, was he able to get past me without attack of opportunity?
Oh, yeah. He was, what, right? Yeah. He was right here. So 1, 2, 3,
yeah, he's,
4,
I got a sweat about you.
6. Oh, yeah. He can circumvent you completely.
He's probably mad because she shot his friend in cold blood.
He's pretty mad. Yeah, in cold blood. With his vibro blade, he is going to swing at you. What's your reflex?
Reflex is 29.
That is going to hit.
I forget yours is lower. That makes sense, but shoo.
I'm squishy. Wow.
Yeah.
He's got to be adjacent to you. That's not lethal.
I don't like the term lethal.
Can... Yeah, I don't like that word.
No, I said, did you not hear me say it's not lethal? I said it's not lethal.
But the fact that lethal was in the conversation that worried me.
I'm just looking at Graz's powers. I'm trying to remember what all he can do in terms of taking damage. He can only take damage for you if he's adjacent to you, or if you're taking lethal damage once per encounter, he can like move his speed and then take it for you as long as he is adjacent to you. But this is unlikely to be lethal damage.
I forgot, and I'm sorry about bringing this up now, but what does command cover do again? Because I forgot I've got that.
I think you get bonuses to your reflex based on being adjacent to allies.
And I think it goes up.
Adjacent to two of us.
Yeah, I am so sorry. I should know this. My apologies.
No, it's okay. I want to look. Command cover. Yeah, plus one cover bonus to your reflex. Oh, come on the actual page.
For each ally adjacent to you.
Get me down to it. Yeah. So yeah, so you actually have...
31.
What, a 31 reflex? Which means he misses.
Wow.
Finally.
Yep. Look at this guy.
Yep. Yep. You move in, and basically just because there are people adjacent to you, you're able to kind of use them to move about the battlefield. He swings with that vibroblade a couple of different times and misses.
Yeah. I like to think at this point, Harani and Reynard are actually kind of a good team where she grabs him. They kind of, it's that Matrix thing where they're pushing each other around to avoid attacks. They're
using each other to copacetic. Cover the blows.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So that's
which makes Graz jealous.
Well, Graz doesn't know jealousy. He don't know how that works. Graz is hungry.
He's got. Oh, did I say jealousy? I meant jelly. He wants jelly.
Kruskog, you're up. Jelly baby.
Jelly.
Jelly baby. All right. Well, seeing as I had fun messing with Blue's brain, I'm going to go ahead and do that with Red now.
Okay.
Because even though he's half cover, the only implementation of this is that it, in this case he, must be able to see, hear, and understand me. And seeing as his friend did, I think this one will too. So even just calling out, behind those boxes, I understand you're trying to make a combative decision, but gesturing vaguely to the back and my right, your help was not. So I would recommend, again, you're losing numbers. Cease this futile combat, lay down your weapons, and we can stop this here. That's a 37, so...
Yeah. Yeah, you beat his will.
Well, like a dirty seven.
Is there a certain amount? I'm trying to remember. Is this the thing that affects by a certain amount or no?
No, it's just whether if it clears his will defense, it goes down to.
Yep. So he is now a minus two on the condition track. Anything else?
No. I've got move action. I'm going to
move next to me so you can hand me that lightsaber.
You know, actually,
and
I don't mind that idea.
And I get more cover bonus, so I'd appreciate
that's
that.
That's actually the other part I was thinking, too. Yeah, go ahead and drag me right there. Yeah, there you go.
Appreciate that.
Seiko's on his own. He hadn't done anything. He's no help. He's quaking in the corner. He's fine.
Oh, yeah. I kind of forgot to move him. He moved into this building a long time ago.
Yay. Makes more sense.
Yeah.
Most of you, all of you will know this. He Ike Clanton his way into that building as soon as the shooting started.
He just threw his hands up.
He clambered through the window.
He threw his hands up and went, Billy! And ran.
Don't shoot! Don't shoot!
I'm unarmed!
His fights commence. Get to fighting or get away. Yeah. He's long gone.
That's cool.
And so you're handing off the saber gun.
I guess if that's a swift action, then I will indeed.
Yeah, you can do that with a swift action.
Yeah, I will go ahead and do that then.
She kisses. Okay. She kisses her Jedi killer and says it was wasted on him.
I will stare a hole through you, both now home. And at the end of this battle.
Chris Cog, Iris, you're up.
Well, if I can help it, Pink ain't getting away because I'm aiming and taking a shot.
All right. Do it.
29.
That is indeed going to hit his reflex.
Come on, big damage. Big damage, like the lazy peon says. Big damage.
Big damage.
Big damage. I'm British.
32.
That's pretty big damage.
Yeah, he's dead. He only had 20.
It's so casual. She's the cold.
She's the cold-blooded killer, not Harani. Goddamn.
Yeah, he's literally running away from the battlefield, and you see Iris just track him and then put him down. He does not make it.
I don't believe anyone else has been attacked, so I'm just going to call it there. So.
Yeah, about to say, yeah, we know for sure red is down two, and then I don't think we've touched green at all yet.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep, that is accurate. Let's see. That's it for you, I'm assuming, because you aimed.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Then, who's next? Oh, it's the original, the Commodore agents.
Red and green, Merry Christmas.
Yeah. green is going to take, like, I don't want to give it away here, but a parting shot. Like, he sees the way the wind is blowing at this point. And he knows that he can't get to Cijo more than likely and get out alive anyway. So he's going to fire a parting shot at, I don't know.
Mo.
Let's say Mo. Iris. He's going to fire a parting shot at you. Oh, what's your reflex?
39.
Oh, yeah. Never mind. Yeah, he missed it. Yeah.
Oh, shit. What's your reflex? Never mind.
He's not that good. No.
Never mind.
No, he did not.
And he's going to bolt. He's going to run off the top of the map there. He's out. Yep. He's gone. Red, from his cover position, is going to pop up over the edge of those boxes. He is actually going to shoot at Kruskog. And he's going to miss.
These guys suck, man.
He's also going to bolt. Well, yeah, they're not trained soldiers or anything. I mean, again, they're Proud Boys. They're Imperial Proud Boys, ooh, basically. They're not good at anything.
Now we definitely kill them.
So yeah, they run, they bolt.
Okay.
As they take off, you can hear the sound of their like footsteps up the steps behind them. But there's yet another set of footsteps that you coming can also down. Hear. The sound of battle has sort of covered the footsteps of the remaining Imperial Sovereign Protectors who are now approaching from the south. Two more appear.
No one invited you!
Everyone invited them. They are the fucking city guard, man. Hey, you guys started a fight.
No.
As far as they're concerned.
No, yeah, fucking Kruskog started a fight. Your boy Captain America up there having to protect the Rhodian. Or whatever it is.
They Duros, will enter the whatever. Initiative order with Duros. The remaining Sovereign Protectors. So, but the other guys are gone. They're completely out at this point. So we go back to the top with Graz once again. I'm going to have Graz move in on... Oh, I got to change my... What I can mess with here. Graz is going to move into here, up on blue. Take a swing. God. Man, that Graz is not doing well tonight.
He's not having a good evening.
The boy's
hungry. It's a 24, and he is going to miss. He has no force points, so that's going to be it for Graz on this go-around. Kruskog. No, Sigurd, you're up.
The other Jedi.
Yes, that one.
Right here.
Oh, hang on, I wasn't looking. Say it again?
below blue.
Okay.
Kyle just clustering up.
Ah, boy.
Yeah.
This is a perfect opportunity for someone to throw a fucking thermal detonator at us.
Shut your mouth. Stop thinking the same things I'm thinking these moments, please.
Two-handed attack.
Okay.
39.
39 to hit?
Yep.
Yes. Yeah, that is a hit on his reflex. Holy shit, you rolled a 19. Okay. Yes, that is a hit. Damage. God, that was fast. Okay. Yes, you damage him. You do that. give me just a second. I think you actually take him down a step on the condition track, too.
Something yes, you can do.
Yeah, so he's in a minus one on the condition track, and you said 29 damage?
Yep. All right. 21 damage.
21 damage. Oh! 21 damage. That does not take him down a step on the condition track. Never mind. I had 29 in my head for some reason.
Damn my honest soul.
Tanner, when someone asks if you were God, you say yes.
I would have looked and seen it. It's not.
Yes, we're all gods.
and I'm going to lightsaber defense in my turn.
Yep, that sounds like a good idea. All right, which means Harani and Raynard, you're up.
Harani, she's going to aim her blaster right at the guy point blank, but then she, as a swift action, she hits the button and the red lightsaber ignites, and she smiles at him. And
underneath that mask, you can't obviously see an expression, but there's sort of like a head tilt. It's that kind of like serial killer thing of...
Wait, what? All right.
Yeah. Oh my god.
That is a 34. Oh, that's a pretty good one.
Hello. Yeah, that's a hit. Yeah, he didn't see that coming. He was fully prepared for melee from the other guy.
All right, and that is going to be... Ooh, 28 damage. She's good with that lightsaber.
Ronnie says, screw Graz, I'm going to do it myself.
Yeah, no kidding. He's not dead, but he's hurting. That's all I can say.
Wait, do you still have two? Can she still do two swifts?
No, I had to ignite the lightsaber because it was in...
But if it was in your hand, it's already drawn.
It's changing the format, though.
You got to change the use of it.
That's the
blade.
Caveat.
It's just like you having to ignite the blade. You can hold the hilt all day long, but it doesn't do anything until you ignite it.
I have to click it. I do still have a move action left, though, so technically I could use Impel Ally to move somebody. Just don't know who I would move. No, I'm going to leave everybody where they are. I'm just going
to... I was about to say, have me move up adjacent to blue that way, or next to blue.
Yes. Way I'm giving you additional cover. Yes, I think that is a good move. I want to move Tanner next to blue, so I've got another command cover. Because I think it goes up to 5.
Oh, so he's adjacent to you. Right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I think that will give me a plus 5 to my to my reflex. And then...
That makes sense.
Raynard is... not gonna hit this guy, let's be honest, because I literally don't think he can. So really quick, I'm gonna look up what coordinate does to figure out what that is, because I feel like that could be helpful.
Is it coordinated attack or just coordinate?
It just says coordinate.
It's a talent. I got it.
Yeah, coordinate, trust, and born leader. It's a special combat action.
Coordinate, when you use it with as a standard action, all allies in your line of sight grant a +1 bonus when they use the aid another action until the start of your next turn.
Well, that's not good.
What's the others?
Trust and born leader.
Trust?
Yeah.
Trust, you can give up your standard action to give one ally an extra standard action or a move on their next turn to do with as they please.
That's the one.
They have to remain in line of sight, though.
That's the one.
Just for the record, what's the other one?
Born leader.
Once per encounter is a swift action. Oh, shit, I lost it. What? It was right there. Born leader, there it is. Once per encounter is a swift action, you grant all allies... in line of sight, please stop moving, Paige. In line of sight, motherfucker, it moved again. once per encounter is a swift action, you grant all allies in your line of sight a +1 insight, a bonus on attack rolls. That lasts for as long as they remain in sight of you or until you are knocked unconscious.
Okay, I'm going to do both, since I can do both technically. So yeah, I'm going to use trust and give that to Iris, because she goes after me, I believe.
For a move or a standard?
For a standard. Standard.
Okay, so I get to attack twice on my next turn, then.
Right.
Or do whatever you want on a standard, but yes.
And then, and then I'm going to use Born Leader, which you said what gives it a +1 to...
gives everybody a +1 to attack rolls until the end of the... Basically, until they break line of sight with you, or you fall unconscious.
There it is. That's it. I'm done.
Okay. And nobody's moving. We're good on everything else.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They are next, for the record. They're going to be moving next. Blue hates everything about this, so he's going to move, let's see, be probably most sensible for him to move here. Well, no, he likes pressing the advantage here, so I'm actually going to have him move up to here, because that puts him near some people who can't attack if he's adjacent to them. Namely, Iris, who he is going to swing on right now.
Cool.
Even though she has a crazy high reflex. What is it again? Like a 39?
39.
Yeah, no, he's going to miss even on a 12. And then this one's going to move up. These guys are just going to split the difference. One's going to move up on Graz. One's going to move up on Sigurd. On Graz, he's going to miss. On Sigurd, oh, I rolled a 12. I don't know why.
Oh,
what's your reflex?
I like the 10 better.
Ooh. Who's mine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
32.
32 with lightsaber defense?
Yeah.
Okay. Because he's going to hit you then at that point.
Okay, is there anything I can do?
Block. You still have block, right? Or do you not?
I do.
Okay.
Thrust. Good.
That is oh shit. Robin Hood, Minotites.
Yes.
Okay. Ooh.
Yeah.
Almost lost it.
You could bug you if you didn't know, wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, because I was gonna say Princess Bride, because they both have Cary Elwes. I think that was the connection I was getting there. Yeah. Boy, what a fantastic actor, Cary Elwes. Okay.
Yeah, pretty much so. It's one of my favorite throwaway things in combat in any kind of tabletop, just like if anyone's
use the force check could be helpful. You could use it to try to negate this attack if you beat the attack roll.
Term.
Nat 20. Tanner, come on. Cody, my character in Final Fantasy uses a rapier, so.
He did it!
How about that shit? He called his shot.
And that will do it, actually.
Nice.
That will work. So, let's see. Yeah, it just negates it. I was looking to see if it did anything else.
Nice.
If you succeed. Oh, that's an area attack. Okay, so you're drawn. He's good. I'm just looking to see if it does anything else. No, yeah, that's it. Yeah, he comes in swinging for you, coming in hard, and you get your lightsaber up and just completely block it and parry it away, basically.
Clutch.
That's it. All I got.
Good shit.
Kruskog, you're next.
Yes, I am. And you know, as much fun as I'm having doing the thing I'm doing, I would like to stop doing that for a moment, because it's a little fun to do some other things.
This reminds me of, there's a lot of little fake movies in Seinfeld, and one of them that I like that they talk about is a movie called Death Blow, and Kramer just starts doing the trailer for it where he goes, "Death Blow, when someone wants you dead, not for the reasons you expect, but for different reasons altogether. Death Blow."
I heard a guy hangs dog in that movie. Where am I thinking what was the movie
It's Always Sunny?
Lethal Weapon 5?
No, it's no. Thunder. No.
The other one.
Is it Thunder Gun? Thunder Gun? Thunderstruck?
Thunder Gun.
Is it Thunder Gun? No
sure
man
Thunder
left
Gun.
Behind. Heard a dude hangs dong
Thunder
in
Gun
that
movie. Thunder Gun is a fictional film series beloved by the gang.
Yeah. Well, because a dude hangs dong in that movie, man.
Thunder Gun 4 is called Maximum Cool. I hate it.
All of it.
Cody, what are you doing?
Let's go ahead and let's do Force Stun, which is going to do the same thing, but it's against Fortitude defense. So,
okay,
I'm going to go ahead. I'm assuming any of these are in line of sight, so I'm going to go ahead and take blue.
They are all in line of
and
sight.
And you get a +1 to attack roll. Oh, you're not attacking. Never mind.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
Yeah. Clearly my last attack went very well with that 0 hit points of damage.
Cody looked at that last guy and went zoop zoop.
He hit him with the finger guns.
All right, use the force.
You made it weird with Santa.
That's a 32, so let's pull up force stun.
Who are you?
30 who are you blue.
Hitting? Blue.
Okay.
Blue so what's boy. His fortitude defense?
Who's asking, Virgin?
Wrong way to ask that. Does it exceed or match 32?
It exceeds it.
It exceeds 32.
Or no, your roll exceeds his fortitude.
Okay, so it moves minus one step at least. By every 5 points when I exceed it, it goes down an additional one. But I'm going to assume that it probably doesn't exceed it by more than just the standard.
No, actually, it's exactly five more, so you got two.
Cool. Okay.
Yep. He's two steps down on the condition track.
Yeah.
Zoop, zoop.
I should have called my shot before that in terms of using the force point, but that's okay.
That's okay.
Yeah.
What else?
That's a standard, so that's a force power, so I need to mark that off. At this point, that's all I'm going to do right now.
Iris, you're up.
Cody made it weird.
I'm going to take me a step back towards Kruskog, like diagonally up.
You there?
Oh,
yep.
By cover.
I'm sorry, I got two.
Don't worry, you still got two of us.
And then I'm going to spend a force point to enact my fool's luck and give me another plus one to my attack for the rest of the encounter.
Yes.
And then I'm going to take a shot at blue.
Yes.
Da-boo-dee-boo-da.
I'm blue. Da-boo-dee-da-boo-da.
33.
That's a thumbs up.
It.
Yes.
That's it. I'm out of water now, too. It's very sad.
With a raise.
At this point, it's almost more... it's also more confusing if she doesn't hit than it's if she does. It's like expected. It's
something like that, yeah. And we have 33 damage.
Not dead, but again, pretty bad.
And I still have another attack, so we're going to repeat.
Do it again. I'm glad you remember that. I forgot about that.
Raynor did a good thing.
And round number two is only at 26.
That is not a hit.
So that's not going to work, and I already used a force point, so... I will use my battle analysis again, though, for my swift.
Okay. Well, you know for a fact green and yellow haven't been hit, so they're not below half their hit points. Blue is indeed below half his hit points.
Okay, cool. Yes.
You know that for certain. And everyone else is effectively out of combat at this point. Also, none of your allies are down. I think only one of you has been hit, if I remember correctly. So
two of us down.
Sigurd's
been hit. Oh, Sigurd.
Nope. Oh, yeah. Well, no, Sigurd blocked it.
Oh, that's right. No, yeah, so it is only me.
Yeah. Never
mind. Yeah. Well, and then you blocked that one with the shield, didn't you? Or did you take one and then block one with the shield?
The blue one I blocked with the shield. The red one tagged me.
You got hit otherwise.
Yeah, you got hit with that nat 20.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. Okay. And that's it for Iris, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Which means we go back to the top with Groz once more. Back at it again with your boy. I don't know why I said it like that.
Hey,
Groz is gonna voice of Wookiee Rage.
Hey, Demons, it's your boy.
Actually, you know what? That's a good idea. Rather than having him move, I will use... I can do a couple different
smash.
Things. I can kick in Wookiee Rage, or... I can use Mighty Swing. That's two swifts, but it gives him an additional damage die.
The
swing.
Mighty Swing.
Sure. Mighty Swing. I mean, he's still got a hit, but, right. You know.
Law of averages is hoping this works this time.
We'll try it. All right, so he's going to use Mighty Swing. That'll give him an additional damage die, and that's two of his swifts. His attack then is going to be on yellow right there in front of him. So.
Big money. Hey, big money.
That's pretty good.
Big damage.
And he gets a plus two to all his attacks, so that was a 15. He already has a 22, so 24, it's what, 39? Yeah, that's gonna hit. No, 38, because it's a 21 for the Viral Blade. But now it's 3d10 plus 16 damage.
Jeez!
Big money.
So, 3d10 plus 16.
Big numbers here.
No big numbers.
Damn.
Well, 24.
Oh, Lord.
24 damage is still not bad.
Definitely not.
It's just not as good as I had wanted it to be.
Coming from the guy hitting for zeros, yes. He appreciates 24 damage coming from anybody else.
Cody's throwing grapes at him.
All right, that's all Gross has got. That was two swifts and an attack. Sigurd, you're up. You're surrounded, for the record.
Yes, I'm going to double attack. Double two-handed attack. So here's my, well, I'm not gonna one hit somebody. So let's double two handed attack green.
Okay. Green, for the record, has not been hit.
I'd say, yeah. And that's probably a good thing to go for.
Where blue is lower, so whichever. Yeah.
Okay, let's go with green then. So that's 27.
27's going to miss.
Did you add your bonus to that, too?
Yeah.
Okay.
It'd be 28, I guess.
37 for the second.
That one will hit. This is on green, you said?
Yeah, 29 damage.
Hey, okay.
Okay. I got to do math again.
I know 29 earlier was going to knock him down in condition, on the condition track. Unless they've got different numbers in the first one.
No, yeah, it does. Yeah, it does do that. And then damage-wise, I'll have to... I got to do the math on it. But yeah, I got it. Noted. Right. Anything else?
Nope, I'm done. That's a full round action.
Oh, that's right. Double attack, yes. Sigurd. Hirani, Raynard, you're up.
Hirani is just going to hold that lightsaber out at blue and just, as a free action, just ask him, are you sure you don't want to just give up now? But she's not
going to respond.
Yeah, say so she wasn't going to give him a chance to answer anyway before she takes a swing. In her head, it was something decent she could do for him, but...
No, these guys are city guard style. They're going to... You don't hear any voices or anything from them.
25.
That is going to miss.
I forget how many force points do I have left. Do I have any left?
You have 3.
I'm going to go ahead and roll a force point.
Okay.
What is it again? 3d8?
3d6.
3d6.
Yeah. They get d8s for being Jedi. Strong in the force. Well, not just for being Jedi. It's a Jedi feat. But
right. 6. Oh, I got a 31.
That is a hit.
And then I believe it is a 3d8 plus 8, if I remember correctly. It is. I am a lightsaber goddess. 21.
That's it.
Hey.
You had exactly 21 hit points left.
Ah, my first lightsaber kill. Ooh.
Now,
how you want to do it? Normally, I wouldn't throw that in on a rando, but it is your first lightsaber kill. How you want to do it?
I would say let's just do it old school Mortal Kombat. She aims the lightsaber at him. She asks, are you sure you don't want to change your mind? And before he has a chance to reply, she just backhands across his throat and cuts his head off.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
And he just crumples down.
Yikes. Done. That's dark.
She's dark.
That's Hirani.
Yeah.
It was brutal. Yeah.
Can you still impel ally?
I can impel to move, but... Well, no, I guess I can do. Yeah, because I got two swifts. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and impel. Tanner's champing at the bit, so I'm going to go ahead and impel Sigurd to attack.
Right, two-handed attack on green again. 38.
That's a hit.
28 damage.
All right. No further down on the condition track, but the damage is noted.
Man.
Yeah.
And then...
This is tough.
Raynard, short for Sprainard, is going to use trust again and also give it to Iris again. Says he's putting his trust in her. And I think that was a standard action, right? If I remember correctly.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, he really can't do anything else. So he's just gonna go. Good job, team. He's gonna pat Hirani on the back. He literally pats her on the shoulder and says, "Good job."
He wants to offer somebody a crisp high five.
That's a nice visual. The guy in the pseudo imperial uniform patting the woman with the red lightsaber on the back and telling her, "Good job." That's what you want with your heroes.
I look at Cruz Cargo. I'm getting uncomfortable.
Yes.
Getting.
It's building. It's building towards something. I got a plan. Trust me. This is my vision.
The plan now is for these guys to take a turn because it is their turn in the lineup. And yeah, given that they're right in place of the, there's really no good way for them to get. Actually, you know what? No. Yellow does have a little bit of a plan. He's going to move here and he's going after Raynard.
Raiders did.
Yeah. he's not a huge fan of this whole scenario. So with his double lightsaber.
Oh, please roll
he's
one.
He's going to swing. What's Raynor's reflex?
I don't think it matters.
Hey, yeah. Let Grosh poke that.
Oh, yeah. That's, hey, can you do that?
Actually, yeah.
Because my boy's reflex is only 15. So actually, you know what? No, I can't even make fun of Tanner because I just realized I have not leveled him up. He's still level 13. So it's probably supposed to be higher. But we'll just call it.
Groz can do it, but just for the record, he can only do it once per round. So if he does this, he cannot protect anyone else adjacent to him who might get hit this round. Until it's his turn again.
I think that's fine. I don't think anybody else is in danger.
Okay. So Groz will enact as a reaction his bodyguard sacrifice. He takes damage adjacent to him once per round. He, because he has take the hit and roll with it, also is going to get plus 5 to his threshold and plus 10 to his damage reduction, of which he already has 5. So as long as this thing doesn't deal over 15 damage, Groz will take no damage and take it for free. But it is a hit, so I do have to roll that damage.
And only because Harani asked him to. He doesn't want to protect Raynard, but Harani, she...
Plus 9. Yeah, it's unwilling to a certain degree. I don't say unwilling, but it's hesitant. Let's put it that way.
It's all building towards something.
So he takes a little bit.
So he deals 21 damage. Groz is going to take 6 of that total. Yeah, that's all that he actually takes in the way of it. Groz basically just shoulders in the way and suffers that blow and then picks it away in the process with his vibro blade. Axe.
Raynard has big eyes right now. He's just...
He didn't see that coming.
No, that put a little fear in him.
And at the risk of putting himself in some real danger, Green is going to move in and go directly after Harani. Your reflex is what with all those bonuses right now?
I got a plus 4 to the bonus, so that is going to be 33.
Yep, he's going to miss. And I'm just going to tell you outright, it's because of those bonuses. That he is going to miss. He wades into the battle, and there's just too much going on, and he's not confident enough to take a swing, so Harani's able to duck out of the way before he can really get any momentum going.
I really love command cover. That is a nice ability.
That's handy. All right. After them, it's Kruskog, and I'm going to run to the restroom, but I can still hear you guys, so keep talking.
Yeah, Kruskog has clearly proved himself to be quite capable in moments of combat by doing 0 damage. So
shit
talking.
He's shit talking.
Yeah, he's shit talking. That's all he's doing.
He's a hype man right now.
Kruskog, just whip it out and get after him.
He ain't got nothing.
Oh, he didn't bring his ditty off.
No, because I was smart about this. Now we've all kind of shown our shit to the city guards.
We whipped it out.
If they're all dead, no one's going to know the difference.
Yeah, but two of them got away.
Yeah.
They aren't the city guard.
The Proud Boys?
But they clearly have the ability to rally the city guards.
Yeah, we got to get out of here. We got to roll.
Yeah, yeah,
we're
calling for help like little bitches.
Oh, they are.
Oh, Lindsay's getting bloodthirsty too. Listen to that.
I don't want to hear anything out of you, Miss Darkside.
Harani's badass now. She's got an earring.
No, she's just bad.
She's got an earring now. She's got two of them. She's thinking about getting a nose ring.
Man, look at this. Look at this. I know what I'm going
to
do.
I just want to point out before Cody does anything, number one, I was gone that whole time and no one made any forward momentum. And number two, Hirani's idea of badass as a female is getting an earring.
Right?
And a nose ring.
That's very funny to me. No, the nose ring came in after the fact. It was an earring. Then she's got two.
Well, God forbid she ever gets her belly button pierced.
She's heard stories about piercing other parts of the body, and it just freaks her out. She's not that bad.
So what Kruskog's going to do is force grip.
Okay, on who?
He hasn't pulled that in a while, so let's do a force check.
I'm sorry. Cody just said he's going to use force. He's going to use force grip. He hasn't pulled that in a while. I'm sorry. I'm out.
Oh,
I'm done.
I invited that on myself.
Loose one of them, Cody.
Let's do it on green.
Okay.
So
that's versus fortitude?
So DC is 32, so it's the top level of it, which means Do I equal or exceed their fortitude defense?
Yes.
Okay. Exceed. So they will take 66 points of damage and can only take a single swift next turn.
F it up.
Let's do 66.
Maximum damage. Come on. That was close.
I mean, that's a three of smatter.
Yeah.
23.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not dead, but he's hurting. I kind of don't want to say that anymore now that Iris has a way to find that out. All right, and he's locked down. You're gripping him. You're holding him in place. Noted. Anything else?
Nope. That's standard action. I'm not going to do anything.
Cruise cog system. All right, Iris, you're up. I'm
going to move back down by Harani to add to her cover bonuses.
Appreciated.
Okay.
And I'm going to yell at Rainer to duck, and I'm going to take a shot at yellow.
I want the new S in the cruise cog system to be standard actions only.
I need to find, okay, while she does her rolls, I need to find something to do with my other actions, because none of my things are swifts.
Yeah, that's what I've been gearing Gross toward. Other than protective stuff, I've also been adding a lot of swift action stuff.
Yeah, and that's the problem I've done. I'm going through all my force powers. Other than force shield, literally every single force power is a standard.
Yeah.
I got a 29 Iris, was that an this attack? Time. Yeah, it was an attack. Attack?
Oh, yeah, on yellow?
Yeah.
That will miss.
Well, we're going to use my lucky shot and try again.
Okay. Is that just a reroll?
Yeah. 37.
That's better.
That's a hit.
That's better.
Yeah, that's a hit. We built a little pyramid here.
Yep.
We move this guy over here. Hey, now it's balanced.
That looks like a needle. That looks like you're going to stick it at me.
Stick it at me.
Stick it at me. Prick it at me.
My vaccination.
That's oh, that's cute. Man.
27 damage on that one.
All right.
And I have another standard action.
Yes, you do.
Because of stuff.
Because of trust.
Because of stuff. Pick it to be.
All right.
Pick it to be. Pick it to be.
So, attack number two.
DJ Balls.
Is 27, which is also not good.
That is a miss, yes.
But I haven't used a force point yet this round, so I'm going to do that. Yeah.
Stick it over.
Good move.
Just curious, because I have someone in my command who's looking to build eventually toward a sniper. Is lucky shot a once per encounter thing?
It's once per day, but you can take it multiple times.
And, so
and I've taken it twice, so I'll still have one later I can use. Cool. But yeah, okay. It is. It's like a once per day type thing.
Cool. Duly noted. Thank you.
Stick it over.
Six. And I got a 5.
32.
Yes.
That's a hit.
Stick it at him. Stick it at him, prick it at him.
Darius, your own ball.
We got to verify that's his name. It is now.
I think it is. I know it's DJ. It's something DJ because that was the bit. It's not just DJ balls. His initials are DJ.
Right. And 33 damage on that one.
That hurts.
All right.
Almost.
Not dead yet.
And because I have lost, and because I have lost track, we'll do battle analysis as well.
Both of them.
Okay. Yes, you're correct. They are both below. They are both below half their hit points. That is true.
Yep. Fair enough.
Anything else?
And then I'm done.
All right. Back to the top then. Is that all you got? Groz is sandwiched here. It's mostly irrelevant. I'm going to have him try to finish off yellow since he's on the edge there, and then I'll leave this one guy
completely surrounded. Yeah, I mean, green is gripped to the point he can only do a swift anyway, so.
Right. So, rather than kicking in his rage so I can save that, let's just do Mighty Swing again. So if he hits, he gets an extra damage die.
Let's do it, Groz.
That ain't great. 22, 7 is a 29, and he is going to miss. And he does not have
a condition track stuff. Crap.
He hasn't been affected by the condition track yet. Wait. Yeah, he has. He got hit for 33. So he should be down by one. Lindsay, you hit him for a 23. I mean, a 33, and then
I hit him,
one of those.
27. No, the 27. Yeah, 27, and then a 33.
27 is not enough to do it. What was the initial hit on him? Hang on. He might actually be a step down. If he's one more step down, it does actually then hit. Nope.
No, yep. I say.
Groz missed him by... Wait a minute. Groz gets a persistent plus one for everybody else, right? Because I'm not adding that in.
Yeah.
You rolled a 7. Yeah. He has a 22 to hit, which would be a 29.
Plus one on
the
you're
giving
bonus.
Him plus one. That's a 30. And this guy's down a step on the condition track. I don't feel bad saying that. You guys know at this point. That is a hit. Because they have 31 for their standard reflex, but he's down a step one. So that's at a 30. Yeah, yeah. So that's a hit. Yeah. Fuck it up. Stick it to
support,
me.
Support rolls. Pay it off tonight. I like it.
The only thing that sucks for me is having to keep track of the good ones and the bad ones.
Right, yeah. Sorry about that.
No, that's... I would rather it
we're,
be...
We're really I'd using our abilities tonight, yeah.
Yes, yeah, and it's good. And Groz just killed that guy, so that's that's also great.
Groz got angry finally and just came down.
Groz is surrounded, man. He's trying to stay alive at this point.
Oh, wow.
So that guy's done.
Oh, wow.
That's all he can do, though. So then, Sigurd, you're going to have to finish him off. This guy's currently being gripped to death by Kruskog, too. Like, he's choking. Yeah.
Okay, who's next on the moves?
You.
I mean, after me.
Me.
Karani and Raynard.
Oh, and her blade.
I'm going to take my lightsaber to this guy's throat, tell him to stand down. And,
I mean, he can't.
I mean,
sure.
He's standing down, man. He's being choked to death.
Well, I mean,
he has no control.
I'm saying, like, you know, if we let you go, stop trying to attack us. Try to show the guys some mercy. I can't remember what that move would be.
I mean, just for the record, he has no way to react to this right now.
Yeah, you're not going to know.
He's being choked. So, I mean, you can say that and just skip your turn if you want, but or like hold. You can hold your turn.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, basically.
You can like set up a I want to hold until this happens kind of thing.
Because I really don't want to try to. I don't want to kill him when he's being held down because he's defenseless technically right now.
Okay, so basically, what you want to do is ready in action. If he continues to attack, you want to take your turn.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. That's something you can do. Because otherwise, like I said, there's no way to know if he is listening to you or not because he's joking. He can't react.
He can't provide consent to this conversation right now.
That is correct. Yes. Okay. Then Harani, Raynard, you're up. I mean, you heard what Sigurd had to say. He can still say those things,
right? Yeah, if
Harani's gonna really hear those.
No.
If that's the, I mean, she's not a monster. If that is the plan that Sigurd wants to do, she knows that's the Jedi way. So she's gonna swing.
I knew it.
But she's gonna miss.
She's gonna miss. Yeah. Yeah. Big time.
Well, hey, if she has dual weapon mastery, can she use the same weapon twice? Or does it have to be one in each hand?
I don't know.
No, what you're thinking about is multi-attack proficiency. So what you're thinking of?
Yeah, dual weapon mastery means you can you're adept at fighting with two weapons or double weapons. Yeah, double attack is the multiple attacks with a single weapon.
Yeah. Wait, so I can?
No.
Do you have double attack or do you have dual
weapon? I have dual weapon. Sorry, I misheard. What is the penalty for firing at point blank range?
I mean, you're gonna have a. Can you?
Yeah, I don't think you can, man. You don't have the action to do so.
Oh, sorry.
You swung and missed.
Yeah, she just.
That's a standard.
She
have a move to swift.
She just really wants to hurt him, but that's fine. She'll I'll let it go.
You just don't have the actions for it. I mean, you got a move and a swift. You can impel somebody else to do it.
No. I can't do that because if I do that, then I'm literally like commanding someone to commit murder in my name. That's too far even for me. So I'm just going to let it go.
Shit. You're nicer than everybody in the Crusades.
Well, you know, they didn't have many Twi'leks in the Crusades. So not many. Raynard is going to once again give his he's going to give it to Iris again, just in case she needs to use it. If this guy is, it's up to her at this point, honestly. So then he's gonna look at her and just say, you know, you're the man now, dog. And then that's it.
Hey, all right, well, it is his turn. So Hrooskog, what happens?
Oh, it's my turn. That's right. Yeah, sorry. I was thinking.
No, it's his turn. Yeah. It is his turn. So he can only, like, he has no chance to break this. It's just he gets a swift action and that's
it.
Yeah,
just a single swift.
Okay.
He can drop his weapon.
I mean, yeah, that's literally all he can do. So with a swift action, he's going to drop his weapon.
Okay.
Now, if that's an active listening to you, or if it's just I'm choking, because the moment he does, his second hand flies up to his throat, mm-hmm. like trying to pry invisible hands from his throat. So it's not clear if he is responding to you, because again, he's got a mask on and you've not heard any comms.
Yeah.
That's what he does. How you interpret it is up to you.
Then Khrushchev is just going to say directly, if you wish to end this if you wish to end your attack on us, I mean, can I ask him to raise his hands? Is that a free action as opposed to going around his throat?
I'm treating that's like flavor, man. That's just an instinct.
Yeah. So, I mean, and that's what I'm kind of thinking the other way is if this character is willing to end his attacking on us, if he can just give us a physical single. If not, I'm going to disconnect anyway, I'll be honest. But yeah, if he's willing to show any sign of resistance, then yeah. No, Hrooskog doing kind of seeing how the party is going. And of course, Hrooskog has no desire to kill anybody unwarranted, will release the force grip.
Okay.
Harani would have.
I know you would have tried.
Anything else you want to do?
I mean, I have all my actions left, so. For good measure, I'll throw in Master Negotiator one more time just to make sure he's a little less encouraged to do anything.
Okay.
So, let's go ahead and do my use the force check. Yeah, that's a 38. Against his will defense.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take him 2 down the condition track and just again explain, we have shown you a mercy today. You see, your compatriots were not so fortunate. Leave this place. Do not speak word of what you've seen. And you will not see problems from us.
So for the record, mechanically, he's at a -5. And since talking is a free action, for the first time, you can hear, like, over robotic comms, very similar to the Stormtroopers, you can hear, like, a coughing and a choking from the inside of that, trying to hack something up. In the wake of what you said, you kind of hear, like a spit in there, and with his head, like, down, you can hear him over that say, it's too late for that. And he looks up and points at the mask and taps the eye portion of it. It's all been seen. You've all been seen, and you're all gonna die here.
Then I wish you no mercy for what comes next.
Which is Iris, which is or Tanner, actually. No, it's Tanner because he held off his turn.
I can come back in.
Yeah.
Well, at that threat, I will double hand attack.
Okay, for the record, he is unarmed.
Oh,
yeah. Think about that for a second.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he didn't
threaten you personally. He just pointed to his visor. What he's trying to tell you is they have like body cams, basically. Somebody is watching or has seen this.
Okay, I will hold off.
He's not like going to lunge at you. He's not stupid.
I'll hold off then.
Just ignorant.
Okay. Or conscripted. I mean, who knows? Hrooskog, you still have actions, I assume, other than Master Negotiator.
I know it's a standard action, so again, turning into that lovely swift and move, ain't got much.
Noted. Iris.
Well, I'm making you one less person to attack us later. I'm going to aim and shoot at him.
That's a dark side.
Okay.
I'm going to miss, because it's 26.
Maybe. Well, he's down on the condition, though.
Oh, yeah.
He's -5, so it's going to be thin. It's going to be close.
That's a good hit.
Yeah, that is a hit, actually.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay. Iris, take a dark side point.
That's fine. I don't have any.
I've got a few at this point.
You don't say, person who swung at a defenseless character.
I missed.
Yeah, I mean, as it stands, it has no effect. It doesn't really actually affect you until you're, you know, getting to the match.
Can I try to, like, block the shot to save the guy? Because I feel bad for him now.
No, she's not shooting at you.
Damn it.
I mean, unless you want to just, like, jump. Well, no, you couldn't even jump away.
Yeah.
You're still an ally.
I like I like Tater's response of, like, you could take the damage for him, but he's like, no, never mind. Let him die. I want to save him, but not at any inconvenience to me.
Lindsay has a bad habit of almost killing me. I'm not getting away with anything she shoots.
Yeah, she's about to splatter this guy's brains all over the floor, so.
Just killed Sigurd yet. I just didn't help him out one other time.
No, but you did almost kill Kraid, so.
Kraid.
That's a different person.
It's the same guy.
That's my brother.
Roll your dice, Lindsay.
I'm trying. 29.
R.I.P. this guy.
Yeah, he's dead. He only had 25 hit points left.
All right, someone take his visor, and we're going to see what information we can get from it camera-wise, like what signal's going where.
At least it works that way.
Because if you shoot his head, we're not going to have much of a visor to deal with.
I'm just saying, we could have got some actual information out of the guy, but hey.
When he's already telling us that, how much do you think he's going to actually tell us?
He ain't talking.
Harani's just going to push him and just say, like, then grab his head and let's go, because if they know where we are, they're going to be coming.
She makes a good point.
She always does.
Sorry, I'm looking for some things here.
Yeah. For what it's worth, am I able to, not that it's going to do much for us, I have improved sense surroundings, which means I can use sense surroundings as a free action rather than a swift.
Okay.
You took my power.
Yeah, well, I'm going to do it better than you, too. So, sense surroundings.
It's all right, Tanner. If it makes you feel better, you can actually
What are you trying to do, just for the record? I don't...
Just get a bearing of... I mean, there's a good point made there.
I need to know what sense surroundings lets you do.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. To make sure I have it.
Okay. Any unseen enemy...
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's all it does, is any unseen enemies in combat. Never mind.
Tell you, ain't nobody else in the immediate.
Right, area. Yeah.
Anybody who was has fleed.
And grab the Duros and let's get the hell out of here.
As this sort of debate is happening from this door over here, Cijo pokes his head out and he kind of meekly goes, "Is it over? Are they gone?" And then he sees the Sovereign Protectors and he's like, "Oh my God, what have you done,
Harani?
What have you done?"
Yeah, no,
Kruskal pops off at that one.
Oh, Kruskal damn it!
Immediately looks at him and says, "What have we done? What did we do to help you?
Yeah.
What Duros have you brought on us?"
I want to join in on that, and Ronnie wants to run over to that Duros, grab him, slam him against the wall, and just stick the lightsaber next to his face and say, "Yes, do tell."
He says, look, hey, it's full on, hands up, don't shoot. Those guys were agents of the Empire, or at least they want to be, alright? They really want to be. But those guys are actual agents of the Empire. They're coming for you now, which means they're coming for me.
Well, that's nothing new on our end.
We need to do something about this right now. I have an idea, if you'll listen to me for just a second.
I know where this is going.
Speak quick.
Now.
There is a pit nearby, one of the major construction sites. One of the accesses to the drains is there. They're tubes from the Plaque City Plateau that have been drilled all around. You know about the drains, right?
Of course.
He says the Empire's been dumping garbage into them, okay? They also dump the odd individual who has outlived his usefulness. Do you see what I'm getting at here?
That you've outlived your usefulness. Yes, let's go.
No, we're going to dump the bodies. Come on.
His suggestion is that, yeah. That you could use those to dispose of the bodies, basically.
Then yes. I mean, they've already seen us on the camera. Does it matter if we dispose the bodies?
Uh-huh.
He says, what camera? What are you talking about?
The guy, she slams him up against the wall again. The one with the helmet said they were watching us the entire time.
He gives you a little bit of the old Dark Knight. You shouldn't ever damage the interrogation subject. They get fuzzy.
Shouldn't slam him hard.
Look, I don't know anything about cameras, but what I do know is that those are dead bodies of Imperial Sovereign Protectors. They need to be gone now.
Begrudgingly agrees. Graz, let's start grabbing bodies. Everybody, grab some
bodies.
Graz
has already got one on either shoulder. Yes. He was on board and ready to go.
I'm pointing at Cijo and saying, you grab one. do it.
It's like he's already like trying to. He's weak as hell, but he's already trying to drag one by the ankles to the best of his
ability. Then I'll pick up his arms. He and Krushkog will work together.
Harani's going to grab the one she cut his head off and just drag him by his foot slowly across the way behind everybody.
Or yeah, all the blood going with it. Yeah.
No, it's a lightsaber wound, so it's cauterized. No blood.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm no fool.
So just to hand wave a little bit of this, the work goes pretty quickly. Seijo was consistently looking around for additional Imperial presences. He kind of has you kind of hide back in the shadows for a second every so often, but fortunately there does not appear to be anyone nearby. It's not much of a walk. He keeps a wide berth from the drain, which is just literally, it looks like a Sarlacc pit in a way, but in like a major area, like in a construction area. And he helps you kind of heft them down there, and then afterwards says, look, it's the least I can do. Come back to my place with me, and I'll explain as much as I can, okay? You guys saved my life. I owe you that much, at least.
Do you have tea?
I can scrounge some up.
Let's go. Let's follow Big Head.
Seijo invites you back to his place, which is a sad excuse for a dwelling. We're talking about like one step up from a tent in the city, basically, is what we're looking at here. But it's quiet enough. It blends in enough with the more of the sort of ghettoized areas around where he is. You know, these people that are being pushed out of their homes. So it's at least unassuming, and that's good for now.
Right.
He kind of roots around in the cupboards and then eventually just leaves the door, opens, and goes, just take whatever you want. Gross does not wait. He starts pushing people out of the way. He's eating stale crackers and like just whatever he can get his hands on. Seijo flops onto the like couch. It winces and moves. You can see that there's like a loose spring where he was, and that didn't feel good. But eventually he manages to relax, and for whatever, he kind of just starts talking to the room, just hoping that somebody's listening. He explains that the Good Feeling, which you'll remember is his ship, returned to Praka's second moon, infested with Minox. Sounds familiar, I'm sure, to you guys. That, of course, was enough of an infraction to finally get him fired. Not only did it get him fired, but there goes his ship, because they all pretty much own the ships as well. His employers then sent him on the next shuttle to Praka. That was no favor. The Empire has made it impossible for him to make a living. Now he's at his wit's end, and if he can't find employment sometime soon, he's going to be at the mercy of Compnor anywhere he goes in Prak City, which you just ran into exact situation of that. And then kind of slaps his big forehead and goes, oh my god, the Minox. Did you guys have Minox on your ship too?
Yes. Yeah, we tried to warn you about them.
Oh. He says, look, I got an idea. I have an idea. Your ship has got to be parked around here somewhere, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sure that somebody needs to look it over, right? Imperial Port Authority probably wants you to have somebody look that thing over before you go anywhere again.
Yes.
Unfortunately.
And he kind of puts his hands up like, I'm your guy. I mean, I don't have a lot to offer, obviously. But he says, trust me on this. I'll have a toolkit this time. I can deliver your ship to you wherever you are. If you've got a crew, I'll stay out of their way. I'll do whatever you need them to do. But you guys saved me. You saved my life. Again, I owe you this much at least.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Agreed. Good call. As the captain of the Coterie, my ship.
At the end of the day, it's your call. Yeah. It's your ship. So
she's going to agree.
Okay. He actually brightens up a little bit, and he reaches out and he does that double handshake where like he grips your hand, but he puts his other hand on the outside and just starts pumping.
The Gil like really Simpsons excited. Handshake, yeah.
Yeah. He's really excited about this, and he says, listen, you're not going to regret this, I promise you. He gives you his comlink ID number. He's got a battered little pathetic old comlink. He says, you guys can stay here, use my place as long as you need. I'll get to your ship, I'll get it taken care of, nobody will ever, you know, be the wiser, and when you need me, call me, and I'll be right there, okay? You're not going to regret this. I promise, you're not going to regret this. Everyone has three mortgages these days.
19% didn't even negotiate the guy.
What he said.
So he rushes off. He darts off toward the spaceport, leaving you guys in his place at night.
Kruskog's in a mood or something about us regretting that. But
yeah, I'm going to take a sleep. I'm going to go sleep.
Kruskog will take first watch shift. This is an unknown area. We're in the domicile, for lack of a better phrase, of someone who is not well-liked in this area. And who probably has made no favors with the Empire. Having a watchful eye is a good call.
Harani is she's going to pat Kruskog on his back and say, you take the whole shift. And she's just starting to peel clothes off looking for the shower. Is there a shower?
I mean, sure.
She sees,
if you want to call it that.
She sees a shower.
There's a hole with some water that comes out of it. And,
she sees what he calls a shower and starts immediately pulling her shirt back down and goes, never mind. Going to bed.
Graz has, for the record, passed out on the entire couch. Uh-huh. A box of crackers directly over his face. Like, he just kind of dropped it on his face. And there's crumbs all in his facial fur.
You got something right here.
You just
here. Just nothing.
Oh, yeah. Good, because we couldn't hear anything.
Kruskog, okay. Wake me up when you get tired. I'll swap you.
Don't wake me up at all, she says.
For the record, Graz is big enough to just pass out on. He may as well be the couch. He's just a little higher up off the ground, and he won't notice if something happens. So Kruskog is the only one staying up then?
I'll stay up.
Okay, make a perception check.
Oh, hell. Oh, Lord! Already.
Hey, that's okay.
Oh, Lord!
Oh, Lord!
Well, never mind. I have force persuasion. I don't have force perception.
Man, stinky
this
crab and limpy
Pete. I mean, you're staying up, so you're keeping an eye on things. This is a version of that. I may impose some side penalties because it's been over 24 hours since you've rested.
Oh, that's a good roll, though.
That is a good roll. Yeah, you're fighting the sleep, but you're managing to do so. As everyone is kind of, you know, rolling around, finally getting to sleep. Within about an hour of everybody actually passing out, so maybe a few hours into your rest, or into your watch, I mean, you get the feeling that you're being watched. But there's a lot of people around, so, you know, who's to say that that's a thing? But the longer you look, the more you get the idea that there's somebody kind of darting from cover to cover. Like, you can see the shadow of them through the, like, makeshift door. You peek your head out and you can see down the alleyway that, like, it looks like something is darting from cover to cover. You can't exactly see what. Humanoid, to some degree. The longer that you watch this happen, and the closer that you kind of get to, at least without leaving the domicile, the more you can see that there's nowhere for this person to go in the direction that they're going. And soon enough, a tall shadow falls back toward kind of a nearby construction area. It dives for a crawl space that's under a parked crane. And you see it look back toward you, and it kind of moves back toward your direction. This thing is as tall as a Wookie, like as big as Graz. But what's weird about it is that it moves with about as much grace, and for all its like height and strength and all that, it has no fur. It's like a hairless Wookie. Like a real ruddy skinned, almost like, you know, almost scarred up type of creature. And even though, again, it's significantly bigger and looking stronger than you, it's like cowering in terror. And slowly it approaches toward you. And then it gets a better look at you, Kruskog, and says, You can tell he's saying this in like a broken basic, like he's trying to grasp how the basic language works. And his eyes like dart around the rest of the area, and then he says, you helped the green man. You help Starib. You help me. And that's where we're going to stop for tonight. That's what we got.
Got a lightsaber kill. I'm satisfied with
it. Eat the naked mole Wookiees.
All right, nobody's watching. Do we need to do the... Oh, yeah, you're going to record it. guys, thank you so much, as always, for joining us. We'll be back. I was like, there's nobody watching it at midnight. There's no way.
I think there actually is, yeah.
Wait, watch it? Who's watching?
Probably Michaela. So really quick, I do want to say one thing. We will be taking the rest of the month off, probably, unless we do a plays. But we will do one more show as a year wrap-up kind of thing. I don't know when it will be, but it will be before the end of the year. So
can we do it the week after Christmas? Because I got all the time in the world.
Sure. We'll do it week after Christmas. So next week, we're going to be off all next week. And then the week after, we'll do at least one more show before the new year. And then on that show, we're going to tell you about all the changes coming to the podcast in 2022. We've been talking about it. We've got some things. So we'll talk about that on that last show. So,
yes. That is the plan. And yeah, if we do any more editions of plays, you know, you may see them, you may not. We may record them and kind of hold on to a few now that we're kind of just kind of free-forming it. So we'll get back at you about that. Keep an eye. Watch this space to find out when you will hear the next installment of Episode 9, The Sword of the Empire for the Dawn of Defiance campaign. But until then, for Shannon, for Lindsay, for Tanner, and for Cody, I am your Game Master Double H. May the Force be with you. We'll see you next year. Later.